and I'ma get it. You know I be on the way. Yeah. You know I be on the way. Man on a mission, I'ma get it. You know I be on the way. Yeah. It's all hard, ain't no fear here. You ain't giving this to all, you steer clear. Never beat, I've been down and I reappear. You got some money on the line, you better put it here.
All right, everybody, it is Friday night and we are resurrecting CG icons because I really want to see McMahon go, you know, come back and do this as a regular thing. I know he had fun doing it and I had fun being on there with him. So I suppose I probably ought to send out the link to a couple more artists too, because I've only got it out there for a few at the moment. And let's see, who else should know about it? Dillard? Nah, Dillard knows. Dillard always knows. Two bullpen, yep. And tonight, yeah, the format tonight is we're just hanging out doing some bullpen stuff, things like that. Just doing some drawings. And what is that monstrosity? Yes, that is Bulgy. I thought Cy might like to know that Bulgy still exists. Mr. Controversy. Don't gatekeep Dean. Why not? I mean, I feel like that's a new meta. Kiwi Skirt, what's up? How's it going? Some Person, hey, how's it going? Mo Biggs, oh, wow, I'm officially a stream. Wolvo in the house. Edwin. And Michael T is here, yeah. Thank you guys, everybody, for showing up. And we're just going to be doing some sketching stuff. I like to do a lot of different things. I'm really enjoying doing a lot of the background stuff for my comic book work right now. I've got a storyboard. I've got to get it ready to get going for actual work here soon. And that'll be great. This will be, well, it won't be one of the pieces in it, but there is absolutely this character in that book. Like the team that the book is centered around is like the little tiny silhouettes all around it. Hey, Dean, what's up? And yes, the link in the chat is for that. The link in the game nights is coming out if you want to hang out. Yeah, this is a team leader of that team, Inferno. Of Inferno, his name is call sign Epicenter. But yeah, I do like a whole bunch of other stuff too. I like doing fantasy maps, things like that. You know, change it up. I am making a whole ass Starfield and Zodiac for a world I'm building that, you know, probably end up on Kickstarter at some point down the line. Yeah, I said it, Kickstarter, because that's where the role players go. And this is Wolvo's OC Mythos. That I just had a hankering to do one day and inked it tonight over on Red Valkyrie. So I've been having fun with this one. And why is my camera the way it is? Why am I the way that I am? Had a character named Inferno. See, I was thinking about that and like having like your standard, you know, fire user sort of situation going on. But I was like, that's got to be cliche. That's got to exist somewhere. And come to find out, everybody and their dog had these. Are these City of Heroes characters? No, older, actually. I used to play the TSR Marvel Superheroes RPG. And a lot of the characters in my book are characters that I played a long time ago back in the day. We're talking like 20 years. Epicenter, that first character you saw, actually has his origins of when I was about 10 years old. Obviously gone through a lot of like different design phases throughout the years, but so this character ranks up there at about being 36 years old, and I've just never published it. They are in City of Heroes, though. Yes, Wolverine is correct. We did recreate them in City of Heroes. As a matter of fact, my the game master who ran my Marvel campaign very much liked to run us through alternate realities. So in creating the City of Heroes version of him, it was just another Thursday for this guy. And yes, Chris, it is. Hail, Sugar. Red Dress Press in the house, everybody. Where's Mermaid? Where you got it locked up, Chris? What the fuck? But yeah, I'd say that this character is around 36 years old now. And just had a lot of fun. Like, and when you're a kid, you don't think of backstory. You don't think of shit like that. That's evolved over the years. And now I'm like truly what's been the toughest part of it is like, because this character existed in Marvel and things like that, and in City of Heroes, it's realizing my own world that this character has been brought up in. Like, you've got to change like all of the obviously Marvel branded kind of things. He shall deny three times before the cock limps. Should have finally stepped out of the bathhouse. You ended the show before sunrise when Ollie was on? What the hell? Sin. Same, most of my core characters in COH I've been carrying around with me since I was like 10-ish, recreating in various forms over the decades. Yeah. And like really refining them, really making them original. Because like, you know, you can't just go with Electric Girl unless you're making like a Golden Age kind of parody. So came up with the name Voltaica. Yeah. Oh, he waited until you got out of bed. Hey, Jason. This is CG Icons. You know, theoretically, other artists will also show up and we'll be bullpenning stuff. But right now, it's just me. Both of these guys could probably just kick Sonichu's ass. I don't know. Sonichu's kind of OP. Nerd! See, he acts like the guy that would play a white green deck, but you know it's just solid black. But yeah, just kicking around. I'm not even 100% sure what I will be doing this evening. I'm thinking about one of my bad guys. And because like all of this stuff is going to end up being like character cards, and part of the campaign will also be like, you'll get cards with each volume of it. Each volume is going to be about the size of like 3 floppies. Guys, you know what I mean. And but each one of those volumes will come with like 4 character cards. On the back of those cards will be game stats for a game that will be like part of the 7th and final campaign. The first couple Wrong Turn movies are kind of underrated slasher flicks. Keep in mind, I will never say a slasher flick is a good movie, but they're up there. When they got up to like whatever it is now, number 5, or yeah, that's just too much. That's excessive. Stop it. Oh my fucking God. Guys, I'm a professional. You know the one thing I do not have in my office right now? Got all my inks and everything. I got no damn pencil. 2 seconds, I'll be right back. Holy shit, this is a shit show. Welcome to the fucking fun house. Crisis averted. Oh my God. By the way, a breaking story tonight. Sugar has allegedly quit his job at the dress barn to become a bathhouse inspector. Congratulations. I imagine that's comes with an increase in pay. Maybe some benefits that aren't quite on, you know, over the table, if you know what I mean. All I say is you don't have to report everything to the IRS. I was going to guess a crossbow was the one thing he doesn't have. You would be wrong, KSSSS. By the way, happy birthday. Sir. They pay him in trade. Rough trade. But no, I'm not going to do like a fucking Paris cityscape. No, ain't no way. Goddamn. No, I will do like a Denver skyline.
Ooh, you're better than that, Wolvo. I swear. I haven't seen examples of it, but I know you're better than that.
But no, you know what? Fuck it. Chat suggestions. What? Yeah. Oh, you know, OG character of mine. You want to see me do like, you know, an existing IP or something like that? I'd be down with a fucking dealer's choice right now. Mainly because I'm not going to be coloring the Mythos piece because my coloring needs work, as is evidenced by the episode piece. So, yeah.
Draw Bloodbone. Who's Bloodbone, Edwin?
God damn it, I need reference.
Draw your favorite part of Isom. I already have, Jim. Behold. Sugar tests every for STIs. He has no medical knowledge, so he just takes a sample from everyone who gets checked out at the clinic. Fuck. Oh, shit. The Ryan Cardinal, creative native in the house. If, goddamn, is anybody else doing artwork tonight? You guys are more than welcome to come in. I'm pretty sure you guys have the link. If you don't, let me know, and I will send it to you personally. No one's banning books. We just want to shut up. Search Bloodbone. Oh, Grifter Meets the Hulk. I remember. Shelby did one of those. My favorite part of Isom was the cerebral hemorrhaging it caused me. Biggs Black Cox has been achieved. Yes. And with 12 in the chat, thank you guys for showing up tonight. I know it's just a blank white sheet of paper going on right now. Draw Truck from Isom. He's my favorite character. I couldn't even tell you Isom's powers, dude. That's how little I know or give a shit based on the absolute shit show. Like, before even this whole circus came around. Fuck. Like, I was not impressed with Isom. Like, it was very staticky. It was 90s in the worst way. Like, everything looked flat and two-dimensional. There wasn't any, like, dynamism in the panels. Backgrounds virtually non-existent. It didn't look like it took place anywhere. Favorite part of Isom 2 is that it immediately opens with saying reboots and retcons, while rare, will be happening. Oof. I'm fairly certain at this point that EJ couldn't also not tell you Isom's powers. Can he fly? I don't know. Based on the one cover, maybe. Or he falls weirdly. That's all I can tell you. That Isom 2, I have not seen that review yet. I think he's still even live right now. Hey, Courtney, how's it going? Isom 2 gave me extreme hope in my piss-poor writing abilities. Oh, don't get me wrong. I do think it's funny and, you know, like Wolverine points out, for entertainment purposes. But I'm like, my stance on it is, okay, yeah, it's over. You know? Like, I get so sick and tired of drama, especially when it's drawn the fuck out. When it goes too long, and that's what's going on. Like, Ethan created a whole new series of streams specifically for this. And hey, I commend the guy. Go get that YouTube bread. But I don't know. It's not about making comics, you know. Okay, it's kind of about making comics, but like the points have been made. Ryan Cardinal, your book was good, and I'm not even into that type of story. He likes chickens. Yeah, yeah. That's why the review stream, the actual review stream, was gold. There's also a truncated version of it out there done by Comics Great, and knocks down that 3.5 hour stream to 1.5 hours, where it's actually going over the points of the comic and not just talking. So yeah, if you're not sub to Comics Gate is Comics Great, go check that out. I don't have a link to it, but and Frog's not here. Or Eric should reboot it with a new title, Isom Hero from Texas. Well, if he wants to avoid certain legal repercussions, that might be the way to go. Although I don't see where like the church kind of really had a ground to stand on, but I, you know, again, I'm not a legal dude. Because their thing is like clearly an acronym. Well, Isom is the character's name. By the way, can anybody tell me in any way, shape, or form what the fuck Isom is supposed to mean? I've never heard that explained. It made July look like a bitch. Yeah, it'd be hard to let go of such a great name like Isom. I don't even know what that name means. I like to do with that what I can with my characters, like actually think about names that, number one, probably haven't been used yet, and even if they have been, at least make them distinct enough, you know, and his, you know, a comic property is obviously supposed to be distinct enough from like a church, but I'm like, the legalities are weird around that kind of thing. Like I could go out and make a comic called Superman, as long as it wasn't about an alien from another planet who's the only survivor and grew and is a newspaper reporter. Like there'd be way too many points of commonality, and you know I get not having that. Hell, DC went after fucking OG Captain Marvel Shazam, the Church of the Holy Copyright Troll. Yeah. I just get Phil Diaz to name my characters. You know, just get Phil behind a couple of pints and just let him murmur some cool names. Well, let's see. Let's throw this on another tab so I can actually see the damn thing. And who dat? Oh, that be Wolvo. That who dat? Hola.
I can't let you sit up here all by your fucking self.
I mean, you could. I was, you know, I hadn't completely run out of it. But concentrating on chat at the same time as trying to be over here, that's a little bit difficult.
Yeah, yeah. Oh shit! I was gonna try to blend in, but then I would be two spaces.
One second. If I do this, there we go. Ha! Fuck you, technology. Right, some person. This is so fucking clear. I'm gonna ink this here any second. Right.
I was gonna do this and try to blend in.
No, but like I said, share this out with some other artists or something like that. If anybody wants to hop on the panel, like, to, you know, and just do some bullpen shit and shoot the shit and talk comics, you know, all are welcome. Okay, not all, but
not all. Most. Not all.
Thank you, Jason. Yeah, the drama monopolizes attention. It doesn't get the fucking books out the goddamn warehouse, does it?
Honestly, at this point, I'm for the drama because it's stupid entertainment. And at this point, if I see one more fucking campaign that I've seen 800 times again, I think I'm going to kill somebody. I would rather laugh at how stupid Eric is right now.
Which is fairly easy to do.
It is. Okay, I'll show like I'll stop sharing this. It's ridiculous.
Oh, hold on. What are you sharing? Hold on. I missed that.
Oh.
There we go. Hold on a second. Everybody, this is the... I think that's as close as I can get it. That is Wolvo's character right there. That's the one that...
Although the belt, the boots, and the braciers are...
Constantly under refinement?
Yeah, they won't look like that. This is the roughs of a splash page that I drew in 2021.
Oh shit! see. How did I? What do I? Oh, man. Oh, no.
Yeah, this is going to fuck up everything. This isn't going to work at all. Like, when I first thought of it, it was going to be like a running gag. We're just going to be like the two of us next to each other, but this shit ain't working.
Not even really, like, actually doing anything at the time, yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
Why do you hate the 90s, Wolvo?
Because nothing good happened in it.
You say that, but...
Aside from the sex I was having, that was pretty good.
I don't know. I'm a fan of the 70s and 80s runs and stuff like that, in particular X-Men. Because,
you know, the 70s were glorious, man.
Oh, yeah.
Like, the early 80s, pretty good. Mid 80s, we're getting kind of chancy. Late 80s are basically, for the most part, by and large, with some exceptions, late 80s are by and large just pre 90s. Everything was going to shit.
I don't know. Some of the art is so goddamn dynamic in a lot of it, though. And I know that you're an anatomy stickler and things like that.
The problem is, like, it's dynamic and everything, but it's like aside from some standouts, of whom I can name Jim Lee off the top of my head, it's all glitz over substance. There's zero substance and massive glitz.
I will say that's what got me to pay attention to getting older stuff, though, at the time, too.
I can see.
Like, that. I had my brother's X-Men run from when I was really little, like, available to go through. Like, I had to sit there in his, like, apartment under supervision and put them back in the bag and board.
Yeah.
Every one of them when I was done, kind of thing. Yeah. And I get it. I fucking get it, because, yeah, he was, like, 11 years older than me, so he was, like, 17, 18 years old, and, like, he's
got this
fucking, like, 8, 9-year-old little brother pawing through his comic books. And he had a bunch of them, too.
I had a similar experience when my twin daughters were, I don't know, God, still young. And I had that moment of, oh, God, how am I going to react when they found my burned She-Hulk run. They're not in as good a condition as they used to be.
Is that a perk?
I'm like, I can lose my mind right now, or I can just say, let the kids enjoy the kids. Enjoy the book. Try to swallow the screams whenever I hear something rip.
Oh, no.
We're talking like 3.
Yikes, man. No, not 3.
Yeah. That's when
you get them like the hardcover Meet Jean Grey kind of thing, you know, like a fucking little golden book version of the X-Men. Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, to be fair, like my actual collection, like from when I was young, like any other comic book collector would see the way I've stored these over the past, I don't know, 3 or 4 decades and like vomit. Cause I've never bought a bag or a board in my life. All my old comics are just stacked up in the order, in plastic or paper bags that the comic shop gave them to me in a box. It's more than a little. There's some Boeing.
Yes, Blood Bone is wildly exaggerated in form, and I'm cool with that. Mm-hmm. I mean, but you can't tell me like Pitt and Max aren't kind of like in the same.
Oh, definitely.
You know, absolutely wildly disproportionate, but they're, you know, fantastical and still pretty fucking awesome.
You've lost your midline again.
Well, see, there's the spine.
Yeah, the spine is one thing, but you've completely misplaced your midline.
Right there.
There you go. That's entirely different from what I think is supposed to be a rib cage, but is almost where the pecs should be.
It's shaping. It's just shaping. That's all it is. Hey, I learned this from Jim Lee. He has a YouTube channel, okay?
Your ribcage is too small.
He doesn't need to breathe. I don't know. Edwin, what are Bloodborne's powers?
Look, he only needs half a rib cage because the only important thing he has on him is his testicles, and they're in there.
Dude, one thing I don't want to do, especially with like a partially upturned face. Now, I have an advantage here because Bloodbone has like a grifter mask on.
Oh, yeah.
I don't want to Cubert it. And you know what I mean? Not Joe, his kids. Especially Andy.
Andy Hubert
makes the flattest faces.
Yeah, yeah. I was struggling because, like, I haven't looked at a fucking Hubert piece in a long time because they hurt me.
The Pokey Puppy's Naughty Day. I remember that one.
I think I remember that.
Let's see. I tried reading the Burn Claremont run. Couldn't do it. Felt like I was being bombarded with yelled at with constant exposition.
What?
Yeah, but that's also the time when those characters got characterized. That's why the X-Men were so big.
What?
Like, and regardless of what Wolverine says, that characterization for each of those characters carried on into the 90s. It was after that I started jumping off the boat. Like, I left after Onslaught. Wolvo left far before then.
I left before Onslaught, but I was aware of Onslaught.
I was finally happy that Bishop's traitor arc finally got fucking solved.
I like by the time that could have happened, like, who the fuck could have cared anymore?
I mean, I did. I bought it, so.
I don't remember, because it's been a hot fucking minute, but
where he had always thought it was Gambit, because Gambit was actually still alive in his future.
Oh no, I specifically never gave any of that any thought because they were just stupid plot lines. I didn't give a fuck to give. But Bishop was a dumb character. But I mean,
he was
like,
cool, and he had a gun, Wolvo.
It was the 90s. Everybody had a gun. And coincidentally, no one knew how to draw one.
Oh, no. It's just making shit up as they go on that.
How the fuck do you build a whole career out of not knowing how to draw what you draw 90% of?
Where the fuck is my blue liner? Oh, Jesus Christ.
I mean, by the time they actually got around to that fucking traitor arc, like, did anyone who actually even came up with that idea still even work at that company?
I mean, yeah, the traitor arc wasn't terribly old. Like, maybe 5 years?
Maybe 5 years?
Hey, that was still a time when people had long runs. I mean, yeah, there were Mavericks and headhunting and stuff like that, but, like, dude, people had long runs at both companies for a while.
Again, I can't be certain that I'm correct, but because, again, a long time ago. But I want to say, like in the time, like, between them introducing that plot line and whenever the fuck they resolved it, like, Alan Davis did Excalibur, took a number of time-offs of Excalibur, quit Excalibur, came back to Excalibur. Like, oh, hey, look, this is who the traitor was. What? The who?
Xavier. Is that why Xavier's in prison? Yeah, they did, like, the Zero Tolerance line not long after that, then the Heroes Reborn stuff, and, like, that's kind of when I jumped out.
It's bad enough how dirty they did Chuck.
You know, that's also the storyline that brought us, like, oh, Cerebro's sentient, and he created, fake X-Men. Like, the fake X-Men were cool characters, but at the same time is like, oh, we're just going to throw him away at the end of this run. I'm like, shit, why would you do that?
See, Edwin, I know bait when I see.
I had this idea about an X-Men-like team, but they all have swords and guns.
That being said, I've been CG since like it started, so that could be bait, but that doesn't mean I don't believe you. I know you fools. Where the fuck is my blue liner? Michael is starting to sound like Sugar in front of the makeup mirror when he's late for a stream. This is a really weird running gag, Mo.
I can't quite tell based on the image that I've got here. What kind of neckline does that wife beater have? Does it like run up to a half neck collar kind of thing, or is it like supposed to be ovalish? But I don't see it on this image.
I said, "Ma, the shirt is plaid with a butterfly collar."
And I can't tell if he wears a belt or not. That could just be somebody's intestines wrapped around.
Wrestling singlet, he says.
Oh, okay.
So that should be. Wait, are we talking like Jack Swagger, like where it's down to his belly button, or? we want to show off the top of the pecs, just show his intimidating strength.
Yeah.
Not that you can't see his like fucking biceps the size of trucks.
Scott Steiner.
That's what the caption should be on this is Big Papa Who.
Oh, wait a second. Like, unless we're going like way back to Scott Steiner, wouldn't Rick Steiner be more accurate? Like, Scott traded in his wrestling singlet for chains a while back. Big Papa Bump. Easy hookup.
Sometimes I just kind of get in the groove and I don't mean to just shut the fuck up.
That's how that works. Yeah. Old school Steiner. Yeah, the Steiner brothers.
Yeah.
Back before he discovered hair dye.
Speaking of which, I also have another tactical issue here on the attack. In both yours and Shelby's images that I've seen of this, I have not seen footwear.
Or should I just add smoke effect and cover it up, or bodies or something? Now what I should start doing is just start doing random CG characters. I mean, I'd still be working on my shit in between, but I want to surprise
everybody. Oh, Jesus.
Like, all the shit. What?
Giant Lobo boots.
Pencils down, folks. Pencils down.
Pencils down. Fuck.
Do they make them in size 34s?
Of all the nights to quit huffing glue. Donald came up with it. Well, that was your first dozen fucking mistakes.
You know what? I do not hate Donald as an artist. I like some. I actually do like a lot of his stuff. It's a weird style. Because you can see like this blend of like three different things happening in it. And he makes it work for him. Like,
yeah, but they're all bad.
He tells me wrestling singlet, and I want to put fucking like fabric lines right here to stop right in his eye.
Like, why'd you put that like gay retarded high school football wrestler or footballer high school wrestling headgear on him?
I was gonna put the headgear on him.
Oh, he's in the zone.
It's like, I'm not actually gonna do it, but I thought about putting the headgear on.
Right.
I'm actually surprised Frog didn't stop in for like a half a second just to say hi.
Yeah, really. It's already in bed.
Oh, wait, I almost Superman mulleted that shit. You get to cheat a little bit with this grifter mask. I like that.
What PC or what thing are you referencing? Throw it in the private chat or something.
Huh?
So what image are you referencing? Throw it in the private chat or something.
The grifter mask?
No, the character in general.
Oh shit! You can't see what I can see. Fuck.
The image that you're referencing.
Yeah, hold on a second here. Edwin, just DM that to Wolvo.
Either or, yeah.
So far we know Wolvo hates the 90s comics, Donal, apple pie, and the American flag. Did I miss anything?
Depends on the apple pie, really. The American flag is dull, but it's okay.
Oh, the American flag's not dull, dude. It's actually, it was pretty baller for its time.
I mean, if you're going to like follow the plot line, yeah, it's pretty cool. If you're just like looking at the design, it's like, meh.
I mean, how would you redesign an American flag at this point without it being, because the point of a flag is the same point as the point of a logo. You want to be able to recognize it from far away, which is why state flags suck balls.
Yes. I don't think there are any exceptions. State flags are awful.
Yeah, I think like 20 out of the 50 state flags are blue field with state seal on them. And that's just horrible.
There are so many horrible fucking flags.
The backyard bathhouse brawler. There he's known as Big Papa Cum Dump. Oh, God.
Oh, no.
I read that aloud.
Oh, no. Thank you, Edwin.
Talk about the logo. He's here.
It's terrible.
It is really busy. I can read it, but it is busy. There's a lot of logos that we've seen.
There is no way that is a wrestling singlet, nor a wrestling singlet collar by any stretch of the imagination. What the hell are you talking about?
Yeah, I don't see a neckline on this, on the one, on the reference, so.
That
and everybody's seen
that the reference. That is clearly still cover. Top all the way at least to the base of his neck.
Yeah, I was thinking, like, I was thinking it was one
like
of those
choker tight.
Like half neck, yeah.
Why are you sitting in this good man's chat lying to him? He's like, you know what? Michael's going to draw my character. I'm going to make him look like a fucking retard.
This won't end up on a back page at all.
Oh, hell no. Everything's valid here.
And speaking of the grifter mask, over the ears, or like covering the ears, or over the ears with the ears showing?
It looks like ear holes from this picture, but we'll wait for Edwin to lie to us again.
Yes.
I can't lie. Like I typically forget almost everything and what it was and almost always what it was called. But this character always rings a bell because no matter who the fuck drew it or what, every time I see it, my first thought is, did Christopher John draw that?
Chris John needs to do a card for the campaign.
The character just looks like something Christopher John drew. Like, that's a Shelby piece, but it just looks like some shit Christopher John drew.
Yeah, Shelby actually did another one of these that he showed on RV tonight. I think it might have been like one that he didn't end up going with or something like that, but
yeah. I don't a lot of things, but I never lie on stream, only in DMs. I done a lot of things.
Hey, not everybody's E key works all the time, okay?
It's true. It's true.
I have a problem with my W key.
Mm-hmm.
Shelby went an interesting way with the wraps. Because it's like individual finger wraps. And then
it is weird.
Forearm wraps.
It is weird.
Instead of connecting them all the way. It's different.
But it looks like it does wrap around the back of the hand at least. At least until like a good half an inch before the knuckle.
Like there's one wrap there.
Because if you look at the base of the thumb, yeah. It is a wrapped around joint. The back of the hand, yeah. But not covering the knuckle. Why each of the fingers also has an individual one knuckle wrap is peculiar. It's a question for the ages.
I think he might have done some fan art, but not 100% on that. Ah, yeah. He showed it off on Red Valkyrie tonight.
Who?
Shelby.
Oh, God. At first I thought you meant Chris John. I'm like, I didn't. When the fuck was Chris on?
When did Jason get here?
When did Jason get it?
And it's a fine line between fighters' wraps and mummies' wraps, and you gotta be careful with that shit.
Yeah.
Read them out loud. I'm not looking at my screen.
It was just a stupid thought that flashed through my head. I think most of it's the pose, some of it's the proportions. But I just looked up and my brain went, that looks like one of those old muscle figures.
Like the Bash Buddies?
No, like the little, like the, they were like an inch tall and made of like
oh shit!
Rubber or some shit.
Machines. Yeah.
Yeah. MU. Yeah. It was an acronym for some reason because that was cool.
Hey. Lay off the acronyms.
Okay. They were like, just flesh colored. Edwin says, "I meant Chris John, but again, I'm not sure. It was a bit ago."
The guy looks
depending on how long ago it was, I might have a vague memory of that piece.
Like Chris John, would have been like, quite a while ago. Guy who looks like he worked as a roadie for Megadeth for about 32 years. But
he drove all the gigs on his like secondhand Harley.
But Chris is cool people.
Like, Chris, get on the bus, man. All of us are riding on the bus. He's like, no, man, I'm just going to ride.
The bitches are on the bus.
The bitches are. I'll find bitches to put on my bike.
What makes you think I can't get my own bitches?
I don't need your charity, bitches.
I don't need your throwaway trim.
Jason Black says, my keyboard is dust, spilt coffee, and cigarette ash. It's my persistence of will that makes these words appear.
That, right?
Dude, that's everybody's keyboard.
Man, I do not want to point the camera down at my desk right now. Oh,
to be fair, I probably have more tobacco wisps than ash in there at this point. Less spilt coffee, because I try really fucking hard not to do that. Because I've done that too many times. Coffee, pop, whatever. Water is bad enough, but anything that's not water, you know you're in for a real bad fucking time, and you're probably going to have to buy a new keyboard anyway. Even if you disassemble that fucker and wash every piece, somehow it never quite comes out right. Your desk is spotless. Just buy it? Hey, you, Pixel.
Hey, Pixel. We're working on AR-13L right now.
Yes. It's a different take than normal, but we think it's solid.
It's for modern audiences.
Yeah.
Pixel, unsub, report. By the way, did Edwin ever answer about the ears thing?
I did not see if he did.
Fuck it, I'm making the ears visible.
But like I said, according to this pic, I think I see an ear. Looks like it's popping out of a ear hole, or perhaps just like, you know, it doesn't, the mask doesn't reach the ear. I suppose it could be either. But then again, according to this picture, this is a choker collar, so, you know, who knows? We're playing jazz here. Dealer's choice, he says. And don't worry, Edwin. However difficult this might be for you, it's much harder for me.
Oh, yeah. Because I'm actually trying to do this in, like, a timely fashion, and, like, I work slower than that.
You will have this done before I would have actually decided on a pose. Then comes the variable length of time while I decide, let's see, reference photos. No.
Meantime, I'm putting out. Oh, dude, that's what you should do for Bloodbone Campaign, is like a huge add on if you get enough money for it. Booby mouse pads with like his huge pecs. Weeks back in the dead of night, I'm holding a coffee and smoking a cigarette, and my fucking Weta is sitting on my arm.
Is what? What's a Weta?
I only know that as the special effects house. Jason's a tech head, though, so he knows what he's talking about. So I'll base it off Wolvos.
I'll base it off mine like half a dozen years ago, because, like, you know, I am not in the shape I once was. Not that I was in, like, you know, fabulous shape to begin with. Even then, it was better. I actually worked out then. That's not to mention the 6 to 15 different versions where I lightbox the shit show that I did the last version. Then lightbox that one. Lightbox that one. It's the bug the effects house is named after. Google it. Scary mutant Satan grasshopper. Well, yeah, fuck I'm that.
Good. I'm good.
No, I know that Weta is the special effects house that originally did the effects for The Thing 2011 that got CGI'd the fuck over by a different fucking thing because the studio said so. And like there's a whole like hour special somewhere on YouTube that talks about what his work on Thing.
And the name in Maori means God of Ugly Things. Damn.
Believe it. Oh, damn it. I have to look this up.
Lobo Boots?
Lobo Boots.
Lobo Boots circa what year-ish?
Well, I have to apparently fucking say DC Lobo.
I'm figuring DC Lobo. But I suspect exactly what kind of boots he's worn is probably somewhat different from, say, Lobo's back to say something in
probably
the last 20 years. I don't know.
Probably the full kneecap version with all of the piece. The question I do have on that regard, though, is do you want them to look as like heavy metal as Lobos are, or?
So my keyboard has seen some coffee. I'm fucking bad.
It was an oopsie, but it has.
By the way, tonight I think the whole room has seen some coffee.
We're enjoying some Pendleton and Pepsi right now.
Lovely, lovely. Edwin says heavy it up.
Heavy it up? Okay. It's the only thing that counterbalances his massive fucking torso. That's what keeps him on the upright on the ground is like the base weights. Sorry, Waldo.
Just waiting for the chat to give me something stupid. Keep me distracted.
Yeah, don't let Waldo look directly at this. I always thought it was fun to get like into the physics of like how superheroes worked and shit.
Yeah.
Like it takes some of the magic out of it. Sure. I do get that.
It works better for some kinds of heroes than others. Pixel says I was at Disneyland all day. I can't be all that witty right now. I don't know if you've noticed. This isn't the wittiest thing going on right now. It might be. I don't know what the hell else is going on right now. Nothing on my list.
I don't know. Is Ethan still live doing his thing?
Oh, no. He finished that long ago. Hours ago. Let's see here. Refresh. That went for 2 hours, 24 minutes. Okay. And it was not nearly as informative or critique-ish as the first one. Mostly because Ethan was just losing his mind. Very, very early on, he would just basically reduce to and this as he's turning pages, and this happens, and some of this, and who cares?
Ouch.
I'm surprised they let you in because of your book. Oh, at Disneyland. New 52 Lobo was a tool, though. Well, yes.
Oh, New 52 Lobo. Suck balls.
Yes. Gayest Lobo yet. and I remember his first appearance, so like I'm including that.
I was gonna say, like, that's not the first time we've seen a skinny Lobo.
Like, remember that original costume? Yeah, not as gay. let's see. I got Ricada. I got us. I got Ballers, which was almost kind of interesting for a handful of minutes when Ethan was on there and they were talking about other shit. They were watching some video with Patrick, with PTP in it when I first looked over, and I'm like, oh, this could be interesting. But then they didn't talk about it anymore. And I'm like, well, fuck. And that's about all I got going on.
And free handing skull faces. No, I've never done tattoos. Right, Ryan?
Hey, man, can you draw like a skull? I'll give it a shot.
Ryan can back me up on this. There's a piece of flash that me and my teacher ran across while we were like scouring some stuff to put up on in our wall racks. Mm-hmm. For you know, the normies that would come in and be like, oh yeah, I want that one. And we were uploading each image individually into a computer database. It was like one of the earliest times that was happening. This was like 2002. So yeah. we were uploading all these things individually, and we were trying to come up for the name of the, we found one that we simply dubbed Tattoo, the Tattoo. It was a dagger that had spider webs on it with a little spider hanging from it, a fucking banner around it, through a heart, with a skull in the background, and like it was every basic.
So you just designed the Uber tattoo.
Yeah, it was every basic bitch tattoo in one.
Fucking Edwin. I should bring back Blunt Talk with Wolvo and just let him go off about how he really feels about everything. Might get some views on my channel for once.
My ticket isn't listed under Pixel Trader. Well, thank God.
Yeah.
What's it listed under? Almost got him.
Almost. So close.
One day.
Next time, Gadget.
Next time. I can't do the gravel right now. I've been drinking alcohol.
I think I'm a few too far in to do that without just hacking and coughing all over the place.
I'm having a fun run with this. I like the idea of just like this big, stupidly proportioned character. That's why I have Rush in my book. Rush is about this proportion when his power's amped up. Like his size and his speed are directly connected to his adrenaline level at any given time.
Yeah.
Oh, hey, we got a boop.
Oh, you got a boop?
When did Jason get here? Hola, brother.
Hola, ¿cómo está? No habla inglés.
Muy bien, pendejo.
No, Jason. No, Jason.
XOXO, ese.
Me llamo Jesus.
You're going to use up all your hours, man. This little duck is going to get mad at you. Little duck in the corner here is going to get mad at you.
I actually get paid this coming week, so I will be able to throw 25 at StreamYard. So. No, well, shut him up for that'll hold the little bastard for a while.
But if you can get by not paying for it, dude, I'd not pay for it. I mean,
yeah.
I don't know. Honestly, it was that one time I had 10 people on panel. It was weird as fuck.
I honestly would prefer to go back to just not paying for it and having 6 people.
Well, you can always just have like just 6 people.
No, dude, people jump in.
I want to add a drawstring right here.
What's going on, guys?
You know, looking at the reference photo and looking at how the pants look, the argument could be made. Like, I could defend that drawstring all day.
Gatekeep Jason.
What did I do?
What did you do to Edwin?
That's what we have Jesus here for, is to make sure Jason doesn't get in.
Oh, come on, Ace. I love you, man. What's going on? What are you guys doing?
I am drawing blood bone.
Mm-hmm.
It'll give you a blood boner.
It already has.
All these messages I got. Look at all these messages I got.
Oh dude, yeah. So when they realized that they were in the wrong fucking chat room.
Who was in the wrong chat room?
Oh, it was like Shelby and Cy and a couple others were like just like talking and chatting random stuff in the topic list group.
Oh, that's muted, dude. I don't have any messages there. I mute that crap. Are you kidding me? Oh, how do I turn notifications off for AccuWeather? Just don't care. I don't know how they got turned on. Wolverine, help me troubleshoot this.
Oh, you have asked the wrong person.
What? You? I thought you were the tech genius.
I can handle my computer, but a cell phone is sadly a little outside of my age range.
Hmm.
I can make mine work. Too.
Is there a 13-year-old in the chat that can help me turn notifications off?
Dean was here a second ago.
Unfortunately, my daughter is not living here right now.
Mm. Come on. What are you people?
She's not 13, but she's, you know.
I just realized I've thrown more detail into doing the boot than anything so far.
I wasn't going to say nothing.
You could always use a good boot. Das Boot. Remember Beer Fest?
We'll just change his name to Boot Bone.
Blood Boot.
Circulation to his leg is really good.
He has diabetes, so he needs that compression boot.
Does this look like it's a sign-up thing? Email sign-up link. What? Why is that there? Why is that? Wolverine, I don't understand what's happening in my life.
Somebody just clipped that sentence completely out of context because it sounded like Jason's like on a bender.
Hear him out. Just hear him out.
That was really the end of the statement. But I could be on a bender. You don't know. I could bend things.
I could.
I could be like.
You could at least crink something.
I am very good at cranking something.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
I'm good at it. You need something cranked. I'm gonna crank it.
He is the crank master.
A crank master. There's the drunken master, and then there's me.
Yeah.
You drunk Lobo? Actually, I actually heard you guys say that before. That's why.
Honestly, I figured the timing and delivery on that was just so that you could only have meant to do that.
I did.
Mm-hmm.
Mm. So what are you guys doing? What's going on? What's happening? Is there a chat? Let me see the chat.
Pixel says, if you're on Android, you should be able to hold on to the notification for a couple seconds, and then it will pop up a window or setting area that you can choose to disable those notifications.
Yeah, there's a... You can do a drop down for the notifications, but it only asks me to mute, like once every 30 minutes, 15 minutes, 22 hours or hour or something like that. It's never like there's no never option. So I don't know how to get rid of it. Like, I don't know how I accidentally even did it. So,
well, I mean, it's an app on your phone. It probably installed like
that's the thing. No. It was like the website. it goes to the website. It's not the app that's alerting me, because I could go to my apps on my settings on my phone and turn notifications off in that section. But this is from the website that I keep getting the notification from. So I don't know how to turn it off.
Michael's trying to heal me.
Michael's trying to heal you or kill you?
Kill me.
What? I mean, is it really such a loss to the art world?
I mean, it depends on given the, you know, which day. Yes.
How is he trying to kill you?
At this particular moment, by these two completely different boots.
Oh yeah, asymmetry all the way.
I mean,
that is a choice.
Like, it's like, you know, I spent the last, I don't know, 20 minutes designing this boot. I'm just gonna start from fucking scratch with this one.
I mean, you ever wake up, put on like two different pairs of socks and go to work and
I only own one type of sock.
I'm trying to defend you, you moron. Just go with it.
I have three of the same ruined shirt, it. So I don't have to ruined make choices it. On the weekend.
That's it. You're right, Wolverine. He's a total moron.
Right?
Yeah.
See?
What that idiot draws two different boots? You know. Edwin,
I respect that. Ha, fuck y'all.
You nope.
No good. I've seen what you respect.
Your boos mean nothing. I've seen what makes you cheer.
It's no good. I've known too many Spaniards.
Maybe I accidentally installed AccuWeather?
Hey, maybe.
No, I didn't.
Maybe the app installed it from the website.
No, it's not there. I looked. Just now checked. It'd be like the first one.
Maybe they purposely don't have a never because fuck you.
I do think that's what it says under the fine print, which I can't read. So
very specifically, fuck you.
Yeah.
There's one extremely Byzantine method to turn it off, but they make it real tiny.
Yeah. They're all out against me, I tell you. All out against me.
Like if you're 20 or younger, you'll figure it out. But anyone else can't read this shit.
Did he drop his stuff in topicless? Let me see. Topicless. I haven't been in here in months.
Fucking Pixel's busting his nuts to try to be helpful. On your Android device, open Chrome. To the right of the address bar, tap More.
I have settings. Safari.
Tap site settings, notifications.
There's at
the
top,
turn the settings on or off.
There's a site settings.
There's too many things happening here, Pixel. All
right, go to Chrome. All right, go to settings.
No, wait, it says open Chrome to the right of the address. Okay, yeah, tap more, then tap settings. More. Okay.
Let me scroll down.
You skipped a step. I thought you were behind.
Right. No. Yeah, I kind of go to the settings.
Yeah.
Settings, okay. Okay. I'm under settings.
Tap site settings.
Hold on. Give me 4.5 hours to find it in this list. payment. Ad blocker. No. Privacy. Safety. Blah, 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 blah.
I feel site like both settings. Of those apply.
I found it. I found site settings. Okay.
Okay. Site settings. Notifications.
Is no microphone notifications
with an N? Yeah,
yeah.
At the top in the setting on or off.
Yeah, thank you, sir. Comfort at last. Now I can sleep. The world is right. There's no more war.
Good job, Pixel.
Thank you, Pixel. Yes, well, he could always stay.
Skip says, I just want to hear Wolverine. I don't know if he just wants to hear me slow clap and he's saying it to Michael, or if he wants me to hear me slow clap Michael.
I think it's just climaxed. What's up, Skip?
How's it going, Skip?
Skip, click the link.
He skipped.
Everybody go sign up for Skip Edwards Arts on fundmycomic.com. Good stuff.
Yeah.
It's got good content on Kickstarter.
How the hell do you have content on Kickstarter?
Shh. It'll be okay.
It's an OnlyFans link. Click it. Just click it.
OnlyFans. Those people. Those OnlyFans people and their degenerative
fans
have no self-respect. I don't have
a not for what they're charging. Hell no, they don't have self-respect.
Oh, Skip, we'll fund your comic. Don't worry, we'll get you a fund your comic. We'll get it. It's okay, Skip. I turned my magnifier on. I can read the chat. It's only at 500%.
Oh,
I feel like you're about to regret that decision.
No, it's fine. My chat actually reads to me and says paraphernalia words in British.
Luke reads to you.
Yeah, I heard one of those, and you fired Angela.
Yeah, she's fired until Sunday. Yep. Dunzo. Until Sunday. We're going to have J-Bot on. J-Bot. Ooh. J-Bot art. It's going to be good.
That's where you've been getting your Spanish lessons.
Sí, señor. Certainly wasn't my ex-wife.
Well, next time you see him, ask him if Hoto is spelled with a J. Because I'm actually unclear, and I want to be able to type that out for the person I'm sending it to.
Also check with him if you can get Bendejo or Pinocha at the mall.
I believe you can.
Well, Pinocha definitely.
Well, I mean, yeah. Pendejo. I mean, I haven't gotten any at the mall since the 80s, but, you know.
Still, you could. It was offered at one point in time.
It's true.
They never said it was limited time. Not your fault. They didn't stipulate.
I mean, yeah, one should have inferred, but yeah.
Professor Murph, I will give you a heart on your little tweet.
Oh, I was over the chat. I'm like, he ain't here. What the fuck?
Wait, Murph? No. Holy shit. Murph knows I exist.
No, he doesn't know you exist. I didn't think so. No. I went over to Twitter because I got bored and I gave him a like because I got bored. Mm-hmm. It's Eric Weathers' handsome face. Give that a like.
No, he cut his hair and lost his power. Fuck.
It's true.
Oh, I was just commenting on that machismo jawline. Look at that. Gorgeous. Cut butter with that chin. That's right. What is this? Is this a survey? What is this? Survey says that I'm not commenting on that. It said Taylor Swift. I don't remember following her, but okay. Clayton Barton. I like Clayton.
Silly little Clayton.
He's a swell fella. You know, the word swell doesn't get enough credit.
It does not.
It doesn't. And you got to bring it back.
Clayton's a top G, bro.
Speaking of Clayton, Michael, you might appreciate this because you were there on Thursday. Yeah. When Clayton pointed out when he DM'd me, and it was the first DM we'd ever had, strangely enough. Did you see the little art thing that he tweeted earlier, Michael?
I did, but I was at work and I was just like scrolling past. I need to go back and take a look.
I gotta skip the link.
The body form thing.
Yeah. I
swear, the last two images were taken straight off the Marvel TTRPG fucking site.
I mean, they weren't bad.
You remember the where you could trace over it to like your own character costume? That thing.
We're tracing things?
Yeah, that's how we roll. But I see, I was really nice, Michael.
I heard that's how the pros do it.
I was really nice. I didn't respond to the tweet. I DM'd him to tell him that those ankles are significantly thinner than those wrists, and you got to fix them pencil legs, bro.
You didn't call him out in public?
I thought about it.
Like, I mean, let's be honest. That's really the character you've developed at this point.
But I'm like, you know, he's got his, you know, he's got his whole learn to draw comics, you know, like class thing to worry about. I'm not gonna fucking sandbag his shit in public.
Oh, there you are.
All right, tell you me to learn how to draw comics, dude. You fucked that up, bro.
Oh, did you see Lawless and Smiller going at it earlier?
Who? A little bit. I only saw the draw over that Lawless posted.
I like Dan Lawless.
He's a decent guy.
Smiller didn't want to. Like, I don't even hate Smiller. I just think he's, God damn it, he's
artistically bland and boring as shit. Yeah,
he's jokey Smurf.
Kind of a dumbass.
Hey, Silver.
Hey, Silver.
Silver, what up?
Yes.
It's yes, both. But hey, points to me that Silvar recognized it.
Yeah, it's completely off model Bloodbone because Edwin does not know what like what the model for Bloodbone looks like.
Yeah, it's just a giant boner with a lot of blood in it.
I mean, yeah.
This is the Hulk forced Grifter to have a baby. Because we know it wasn't the other way around.
I mean, he could. And Grifter couldn't.
Grifter was impotent?
No, I mean, if you're going to pick between those two, who's the top in the relationship?
Yeah, Hulk could force Grifter to have a baby. I don't think Grifter could force Hulk to take a baby.
No, but I mean, you know, to subvert expectations, Hulk could be the bottom.
This is not for modern audiences.
But even if we're going there, like just looking at Hulk, he's probably a power bottom.
Oh, he's probably a power bottom without a doubt.
Yeah, I mean,
come on, you know, look at those quads.
I mean, that motherfucker tops from the bottom all day long. Yeah.
He's a sassy glutes. Power bottom. Okay.
Yeah. He knows how to thrust the glutes.
Yeah.
I thought it was pit sodomized Grifter.
No, I can't do it. I can't do it. Michael. The shoulder on the right.
There's shoulders on your right hand side?
His right or my right?
On the right of the page. Yes.
That didn't answer the question.
That shoulder line literally cannot overlap the bicep. The bicep goes under that shoulder muscle.
Oh, yeah.
Well, I'll let everything else pass. Okay, carry on.
I'll let everything else pass. What's wrong? What's wrong with the image, Wolvo? What could possibly be wrong?
Fuck you, we've met.
Okay, how big of a package am I working with here? Okay, Edwin? What am I?
Looks like a good 6-incher.
Huge sausage or like kielbasa? What are we talking? Kielbasa.
Is he a grower, not a shower?
Mm-hmm.
Although the Shelby piece looks like he has heavy knob syndrome.
Well, I mean,
tiny little stem, massive knob.
It's Shelby. What do you want?
Where are my smokes? There's my smokes.
He accepts certain areas.
He draws what he knows.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Draws from life, as one should.
Wolver is this close to sending Michael a night litter. Well, his arms reach his toes while standing up straight.
I mean, Edwin, it's not like Michael was doing that Mythos piece on Regen Cycle. It's not like it's not like the first message I sent him wasn't turn that page every once in a while. You're doing some of these at really awkward angles.
Yeah, I was sitting there like holding my hand like this right here on a couple of these, and I'm like, I should just,
You're just working on the line of the cape. I'm going, those are getting kind of weird, but that's a really weird angle. Like, just move the paper. It'll be easy.
Yeah, wait, there's the paper moves?
This piece from earlier.
The paper moves.
It's really hard to pick up my whole computer monitor and turn it while I'm...
Right?
Get an arm.
One of those fucking LCD monitors and shit.
Get an arm. Just get one of those, you know, swivel arms.
Edwin, Chad is supplying some absolutely fantastic ammunition and possibilities for this character at this point. You can skip the package size by putting a smaller grifter mask over the groin.
Oh, there you go.
And Pixel Trader says, Little Smokies, implying plural.
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, he's got two. That makes sense.
I don't know. I don't know. They're Little Smokies. You're going to need at least a handful.
The Vienna sausages. And Edwin hasn't replied in about 2.5 minutes, which means he's, oh, he's a there double he masker.
He's a double masker.
I am not adding a second little mask down here.
Keep it secret. Keep it safe.
It'd be pretty cool if you did.
It would be, but.
But just a half mask. So it just like hangs. It just hangs down a few inches from, or just like right from under the head.
Like my own artistic integrity is telling me don't do this to this type of character.
But the part of it, the psychology is all for it.
Do it. Be one with it.
Yeah, dark I say that side. Kind of thing, but then I go and draw this goddamn monstrosity.
Yeah.
See, Jason, Bulgy still exists. Bulgy lives.
Why do you hate everybody?
What did you? We're just all glad that it's actually impossible to make anything like that in City of Heroes.
Look at that package.
I will say, you at least made it look like a good piece of artwork.
It's true.
Behold.
Like, it is just about unrecognizable.
Thank you, Michael.
I already got the costume saved. Bulgy? What the fuck, Silver?
No, I don't believe any of this, because if Bulgy could actually be made in City of Heroes, especially if you could make him giant, then Michael would have already made an AE arc about it.
The fucking the football Calvin, or the football Stewie head, that, yeah. That'd be the wild part.
Can you just imagine if you could make a fucking AE mission arc? Just a whole fucking chain. Fucking Bulgy.
Well, and again, I don't want to spoil my own fucking comic, so I don't want to say how Bulgy plays a part.
I got a question, Michael. Are you drawing it?
What?
Your comic. Are you drawing it?
Yes.
Then you already spoiled it.
I mean, should I hire somebody else to do it? Wolfo's like, yes, God, yes.
Yes. Do you want backers?
Hold on, I hear a boop.
Boop. There's a boop.
There's a boop. Oh, holy shit. Boop. Hi, Skip. How's it going?
Oh. What's this?
When did Skip get here?
What's up, Skip?
Been here all night, Wolverine.
Yeah. He's been in backstage for like an hour and a half.
It's true. It's true.
Just listening for a slow clap.
Somebody told Jason to gatekeep, so I've been letting him gatekeep Skip all night.
Did you just slow clap me, motherfucker? It was the best stream I ever saw. It's been years.
I can. You. Here. No compromise. Golf clap.
I just cleared my throat. Sorry, I muted.
Couldn't golf Thanks clap. For taking your shirt off first.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
Mm. How'd you know I took
Adorable my shirt off? Of you to think it was ever on.
No, it's Skip knew I took my shirt off. I didn't know.
Is there cameras in my room? The cameras, dude.
I was going to say, Sai has cameras everywhere.
Wow. It's fed into Skip's room, too.
No, it's on the internet, man. We just know where to look.
Yeah, you just got to get past the paywall.
My most humble apologies.
It's on Sai's OnlyFans.
Oh, well, at least they might get an OnlyFanner. What are they called? Are they called OnlyFanners?
OnlyFanner?
What are they called? What do you call those things?
Pornographers.
Suckers, that's a good one too. Yeah.
Is you're going for those who pay for OnlyFans, not those who are on OnlyFans, right?
I'm just gonna start calling them OnlyFanners. I like it.
I hear there's a great 3D effects artist looking for comic work.
Well, to be fair, it's OnlyFans. So if you're referring to people who pay for OnlyFans, not the ones who have OnlyFans accounts, then they would be OnlyFappers most of the time.
Yeah, but how do you know they're just not only collectors?
Because it's OnlyFans.
Mm-hmm. Oh, so did you hear about Edwin the one guy who paid like $10,000 for a quote unquote meet and greet, where usually you end up, you know, other stuff, and all she did was give him a hug and then left like immediately, like she had a press conference somewhere.
Dude, that's a baller move, man.
Or the other guy who was like this, I think it was Twitch or something like that. He was her top donator and one of her mods, and he came to a con to meet her, and she literally ignored him. He walks up next to her, tries to get like a lean in hug, and she just walks away. Doesn't look at him, doesn't speak to him. And his friends are there going, "Oh shit." And he's trying not to show how much he's dying inside and failing.
Is it bad of me to say I think this might be one of the better pieces I've done in months? It's also one of the only pieces I've done in months.
I wouldn't brag about it.
I'm having fun with it. That's the important thing, right, guys?
I'm sorry, I fell asleep for a minute. What?
You've seen a lot of F's in the chat.
Yeah.
Oh, no, it's copyrighted work. Shit. Oh, no.
You know what?
Well, yeah, there you go, Silvart, asking
permission. Yeah, look at you.
Thoughts deserve nothing. If she breathes, she's a thought.
You know what's weird, though? Everyone remembers when Mia Khalifa got hit in the boob with a hockey player, but no one knows the hockey player's name.
Who's Mia Khalifa?
Nice try.
She's an OnlyFans person. But, like, I've never heard someone say, like, oh, yeah, like, Jeremy Roenick hit this person with, like, a hockey puck. It's always, like, about her boob or her.
That could very well because even though you literally just said his name, like, I have no idea who he is or what his name is.
I don't watch hockey, so.
Are you saying
he's got a great stream.
Are you guys saying that porn's more popular than hockey?
It's a fringe theory, I know, but
who's hear me playing out here. Hockey, though? Are the porn stars playing hockey? It. Because
yes, yes.
Oh well, then they're both getting good views.
Yeah, they all have little hats and little bow ties, and they're bouncing on dick.
And not everybody knows this, but porn has decided the direction of media and its formats for decades.
Yeah,
since like the '70s. Yeah,
I learned that in Tropic Thunder.
Okay.
I don't remember that in Tropic Thunder, but okay.
You remember Tropic Thunder where they're walking through the field and the dude is talking to really nobody but everybody because no one's listening to the nerd? And he's like,
I do vaguely remember it coming up, but I don't remember.
Yeah. And he's talking about, it was Blu-ray or it was DVD or 4K. He's like, what really ended up
winning
was what the porn industry did. Yeah. And then he's like, so you've been talking this whole time.
So Beta versus VHS.
Dude, I love that movie. Come on.
HD DVD versus Blu-ray,
yeah.
Hey, Jim Cox is here. He says only skip things of hockey players over boobs. It's true.
It's true.
Okay, well, I have to end the stream because of symmetry.
What's up, Jim?
Jim Cox was the first person to ever comment on one of my streams. It was my first MMM, and now he will be the last. Good night, everybody.
Good night, everybody.
I still love you, Skip, or Jim and Skip. I love you both.
Wait, do we get to keep the stream going if Jim Cox just fucks off?
Oh, shit.
Questions for the ages.
Ugh. Are you going to color this?
I mean, should I?
Sure, why not?
I mean, well, why not, you ask? Well, I have an answer.
That's not the same picture.
Okay, why not?
My coloring needs work.
To be fair, we've covered a lot of fucking books with worse coloring than this.
Let me ask you this. Is that blood bone piece going to be printed?
I don't know. Edwin?
Do you plan on selling it?
Not that I was aware of.
I don't know, Edwin.
All right, well then have some fun.
I don't know, coloring. Edwin.
Just do it.
I appreciate you for buying that colored piece I did of the Defenders of the Earth.
That was a good piece.
I had a lot of fun doing that one.
I got your only good piece.
that kind of crowded the page. No, who was it? Blue Samurai Zero got my original Epicenter cover.
And?
It was pretty good, too. He was all blasting.
For her sake, I had always hoped that Chris had his only good piece.
Ed was just colored up. God damn it.
Yeah. Thank you.
The creator said do it. He trumps all of you fuckers.
I think Trump trumps people. His
Trump don't even
name.
Play Pinochle.
Right? No, but it's his name. It's in his name. It's Trump. I trumped you. You mean this isn't AR-13L? How dare you?
No, it is. We said it was.
I was so close to finishing.
This is totally AR-13L.
Now I got to start all over again.
This is the redesign.
Based on what I'm seeing from the other image, if I put her in here, she would be this tall. When he walked, he would spike her in the back of the
head. Dude, crossover, man. Do it. Maybe this could be in both books.
I don't... Where am I going to put her now?
Skip, can you believe what we're hearing here?
You have already indicated how big she is. Just draw her in there as a dick puppet.
She's the second mask.
Yes. I am Bloodbone, and this is AR-13L, or this is my dick going for Halloween as AR-13L.
Oh my god. what have I wrought?
So far is correct. I give no fucks at all times. It's kind of my brand.
I mean, I guess I'm not a creator per se. More of a innovator.
Or create him, Jim. Really.
I'm more of an innovator, Jim. More of a visionary, if you will. You know.
See, that's why I didn't try to put Jason in a bubble.
Yeah, don't bubble me, yo. Can't bubble me.
Can I double bubble you?
Double bubble. That would be more the...
That would be a strong maybe, sir.
Right?
Starfish jab. Job. Starfish job. See, I got there. I read it.
Yeah.
I'm doing really good. Doing really good as your co-host.
Yeah, yeah. 500 times is working out for you.
Jason is the innovator. That's it. I'm gonna end it right there. Innovator of creation. I actually like that even better. So I'm gonna use the whole thing.
Yeah. Like
the question I always wanted to ask Pixel is: he does realize where the mouth on a starfish is, right?
Look it up.
Oh, I know what.
Skip's muted, man. Why is Skip muted? Skip muted?
I'm not muted.
Why are you muted?
I'm not. Am I?
What? Skip.
Can you hear me? Can anyone else hear me?
What's up, Skip?
When is Skip? Oh,
hey, there you are. Hi, Skip.
Have you been here the whole time?
Whole time.
Just got here.
Haven't had anything to say.
What's going on, man? What have you been doing?
I was sitting in the back room for a while. And then I came on the stream.
So you're just staring into the abyss of nothingness?
Screaming into the void, waiting for
my
audience.
Is that why you were muted? Because you were screaming into the void?
No, I'm getting over a cold. I was coughing.
Busted. When's your book coming out?
I want you to write. I don't have a book.
Tired of this garbage. Put everyone to shame, Skip.
Why is asking it?
Don't somebody link that.
Why is everyone always asking when someone's book's coming out? Like everybody's book is gay.
Well,
how did you know the plot to Skip's book?
No, I finished that book.
Oh,
Skipgate kept himself.
Is that on Kickstarter? Is that one on Kickstarter?
Yeah. Well, I figured I would just have a late book and like just skip the crowdfund part. So I just have a late book.
There you go.
Oh,
there
that's smart, man. You're gonna get so many refunds.
Mm-hmm. Actually, I'm not gonna get any refunds because nobody paid. I just have a late book.
Yeah. Let's go right to the end.
They get to complain for free.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, you're getting the complaints. This is boss. This is OG
I checked.
Level.
I'm not trending yet, but it's gonna catch on.
When you do, you're going to get so many complaints.
This is the new business platform. This is the real shit.
Skip is reinventing the meta here.
Yes.
And I'm in for it.
Tell me you don't have a book. You have a book.
Yeah, I was one of the campaigns that got doxxed, so I pull it down, and I was just kind of like never put it back up.
Oh, the mailing list. That's why.
Oh, yeah. Oh, I know what you mean. I was like, what do you mean got doxxed? I'm like, oh, I remember now.
Yeah, when Indiegogo was sharing home addresses.
Yeah. So ridiculously crazy, dude. Oh,
damn. And then, well, when he comes up with a new one, everybody keep an eye out for sleight of hand. Yeah, you thought I fucking forgot, didn't you?
That is it. I got a Liam in the chat. Hey, Liam.
Hey, Liam.
So Liam's in the chat.
Yeah.
What's up, Liam?
Where I actually jumped on and streamed with Liam the other day, and then I woke up with a cold like that night. It's probably just something going around.
Liam gave you the cold from Australia.
Directly linked causality. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
That checks out.
Yeah, no, exactly. I think it was somebody at work, but it just like happened out that way.
Those Australian viruses are potent.
Yeah, you don't need to cover for Liam on this one.
Potent. I mean, have you seen their spiders? Come on. You know their viruses are boss level.
You guys should send Liam the link. He probably will have energy. I don't. Then I'll just have an avatar on mute.
It's not yeah. That energy.
Everybody can be on mute.
Yeah. Mute stream. The new hotness.
Well, this is CG icons. It didn't say anything about CG voices.
Yeah. Or cams. None of that shit. Only icons.
Aren't our avatars enough?
It's too much sometimes.
Mm.
And looking over at the screen. Oh, yeah. Skip is here. I mean, Liam is here.
Yes, Skip is here.
I've been here.
How long you been here, Skip?
Since the beginning of the movie.
Wait. When did Skip get here? And Michael, did you cut your hair?
Fuck.
Don't slow clap me, motherfucker.
I can't even remember what inspired me to, like, obviously Wolvo was doing a slow clap, but I don't remember what to.
I did a golf clap, and I honestly have no idea what to.
Just skip. Yeah. I buzz all day, every day, yeah.
Edwin says, I'm going to start a new stream called CG Gatekeeper. Only Wolvo will be allowed on.
That's racist.
That's the new meta.
Yeah. That's the shit right there.
I want to start a stream just defending movies everybody hates.
What's your first movie?
Man of Steel.
I was going to say, it's got to be Last Jedi, right?
Oh, when did Skip leave?
Skip. It's, hey, guys, Skip. I'm back.
It's hashtag kick Skip.
He's right there. Skip's right there. What, you liked Man of Steel?
I think people don't understand it.
I do.
Oh, I think Man I do.
I do. No, okay. Seriously, do.
Hold on. Man, no, I want to hear...
It's the finest live-action Dragon Ball Z movie we've ever had.
Dude, I want to hear Skip's reasoning behind his defense.
Jonathan Kent dies at the beginning, right?
Yeah.
So it's basically about this kid with superpowers that has a hot mom, and he basically forces her to be single for the rest of her life.
I'm waiting for the part where it's a Superman movie.
No. Keep going.
Superman, like that could be your stepson if you try to hook up with his hot mom.
It could be, so but
he just goes around killing people.
So you're saying Man of Steel is a precursor to popular stepmother porn films?
It's basically a remake of Problem Child.
I see that connection. Yeah,
I was thinking about it today when I was in the back room before I came.
Well, there's a problem. I hated Problem Child.
I liked Problem Child, but only for John Ritter.
No, Problem Child 2, that's where the money is.
Like, everything but John Ritter sucked.
So, Superman
like Man of Steel.
So if you look at Man of Steel and Brightburn, like in Brightburn, he has a hotter mom and he's more evil.
I think he just proved my point by bringing up Brightburn.
Right. So, but Man of Steel, it's not about Superman. It's about his love. Requited love. It's kind of like, what is that? Who's that? Is it Othello? Who's that guy that wanted his mom in Shakespearean time? Who was that?
Oedipus.
That's it. Thank you. Great. Is it a retelling? Yeah, whatever. Wolverine. I'm not smart.
I'm checking the chat to see if Oedipus is in it.
So it's like a retelling of that. Is that what you're saying?
I feel Jason is onto something. That would be funny if you took that line of defending movies where your video essay is how it's actually stepmom born.
That's what I thought he meant at first.
Just go through every movie you can find. Hey, what's up, Brian Cardinal? It's the stepmom porn, and this is why.
Yeah, it's like a precursor to it.
When you do your meta tags for the channel, make sure you add hashtag stepmom. I guarantee that'll get in front of a lot more eyes.
Also, add stepson just to cover both ends.
Yeah, but you don't want those bots back, you know.
Hey, each one of those bots is a subscriber. Don't shame them.
No, they don't subscribe, dude. It sucks.
Dude, my follower account has fucking exploded in the past month. Yeah. Shut up.
They don't add to watch hours or anything. It sucks.
It does suck.
Wish they did. I'd be monetized by now.
To Kill a Mockingbird? Stepmom porn. Here's why.
Always was.
Mm-hmm. I'm listening.
Hit me. Pull it up.
At first, you had my curiosity, but now, sir, you have my attention.
Skip has not lost his mind. He's making perfect sense, Ace. He's kind of got me on board with this whole Superman thing. I think it's a good movie now.
Do you remember there was like a Twitter trend like years ago now, but it was explain a movie badly?
Oh, yeah.
Kinda.
Maybe we could just look that up and make our show about that. Jason's gonna do the show with me.
Like my personal favorite one of those was show. Young woman arrives in strange country and murders the first person she sees. She gathers three friends to murder again. The Wizard of Oz.
I like the one where it was a pirate and his puppy friend travel universe to save incest couple for Star Wars.
Nice.
Actually, I'm just gonna search that now. I want to remember more.
I usually just said what the movie was.
Yeah. You do these long form 20-minute videos that start with a serious intellectual movie, music scripted to the limit, like you're right out of the film school.
All right, guess this one. Stripper learns to become a Navy SEAL while hiding in a cake.
Oh, that's Under Siege.
Dude. Under Siege,
Erica Laniak. Fuck yeah.
Erica Laniak. Oh,
my
shit.
My VCR tape was like worn thin during those 18 seconds. Okay? I had to get a whole new fucking VHS because of that shit.
Don't look her up now. Don't do it.
Don't do it now. No.
No.
Look her up then. Look her up then. You'll be happy.
Yeah.
Fond memories.
I respect all of us for immediately getting that.
I think that one was one of the easier ones, though.
So. Yeah.
Don't spill the soda on
How
the
long was she in that cake?
Long fucking enough.
Until she became a Navy
SEAL. Yeah, long enough to be a Navy SEAL.
I mean, she had to hold her breath for a long time, man. I guess that is a requirement for being a Navy SEAL.
I don't know.
Oh, here's a good one.
How long does it take to bake a cake, Jason? She was in there at least that long.
You got a point. You got a point.
All right, here's a good one, but it's so vague you won't be able to guess it. World's worst haircut turns man into remorseless killing machine.
Is it Terminator?
Eraserhead?
Wolverine? World's worst haircut turns man into remorseless killing machine.
Falling down.
Edward
Scissorhands. Oh, that would be perfect, wouldn't it? Fine, that would make sense so better than this. It's No Country for Old Men.
Oh, fuck.
That's valid, but I wasn't thinking that far.
I think falling down's better.
Falling down's better. Falling down's way better.
It probably is. It's probably better than my guess of Edward Scissorhands.
That one's good, too, though. But he doesn't really kill anybody.
But it was a terrible haircut.
It was a terrible haircut. He gave dogs terrible haircuts, too.
Why am I the only one drawing on a draw stream?
I ask myself that question all the time. Now you know how it feels.
I do, and it feels bad.
Doesn't it? It's awkward.
I mean, to be fair, I only came up here because Michael was all by himself and floundering.
I was not floundering, sir. I was engaging with the chat and not drawing a goddamn thing.
Wait, people were actually watching you before Wolverine got
here? There was like a dozen people in here.
I don't believe you.
Oh, it was Edward Penis Hands. Edward Penis Hands.
It's a different movie.
I mean, there might also be a Foreskin Hands. I mean, you know, it's not like anyone has a fucking monopoly on porn parodies.
Well, I mean, Foreskin Hands wouldn't leave fingerprints.
It's true.
All right. This one's pretty good. A cat lady watches as everyone around her dies, leaving her all alone with a cat.
Lady.
Wait, it's a movie where everybody but a lady with a cat dies, and she just stands there and watches everyone die.
Sleepwalkers?
Alien.
Oh shit!
Now, Sleepwalkers is a lady who is a cat.
Yeah, I know, I know. I knew.
That was the Borg Queen in fucking.
It was.
Alien. I should go.
She was never pretty.
She was pretty when she turned into a cat.
She was also the girl who the old man killed and came back as a ghost in the movie Ghost Story with Fred Astaire and I think Don Ameche and a few other old guys. But I think I'm reaching back to the late 70s for that one.
All right, here's one. Guy travels back in time to bang his best friend's mom.
Oh, that's Back to the Future.
Terminator.
Oh, no, Terminator. No,
that's his own mom in Back to the Future.
Exactly. Yeah.
Yeah, it's Terminator.
To be fair, Jason's named Terminator for every one of these.
Just two. Just two. And you got to admit, come on, his haircut wasn't the best in Terminator, so I kind of had a good train of thought there.
Yeah.
Very cool machine. I have logic and reason to some things I say. See, look at even Pixel Trader said Terminator. See? People agree with me all the time.
All the time.
All the time. Never been wrong. It's a curse.
Someone put an end to it.
Can't stop. Won't stop.
Oh, this crack, is crack, great. Bow. White guy travels to Asia, becomes a samurai, meets machine gun.
Terminator.
Yes. I forgot. It's the Last Samurai.
With Tom Cruise. Yeah. Yeah, he gets killed by the militia dudes and stuff. Yeah.
See, I was gonna say Blind Fury.
I knew that one was Last Samurai.
No, Tom Cruise survived that movie.
No, he didn't. He died, dude. He died.
He only imagined he died.
No.
Oh, this is good. Local man helps teens fight narcolepsy.
Nightmare on Elm Street. Nightmare on Elm Street. Yeah.
Wolverine had it like instantly. He was chuckling.
I was thinking Friday the 3rd. I was like, Freddy, Friday. I'm like, it was there.
Yeah. I stumbled over the F there.
Yeah. Dean's in the chat if anybody cares.
He is.
Who?
I already forgot.
Good day, Dean.
Oh, shit. Dean graduated a full Nazi.
Which Dean? Cool.
I know Nazi Dean.
The Nazi one.
No, Silver, that was 47 Ronin.
Yeah,
Yeah, the one where everybody committed seppuku.
You have brought dishonor on your cow.
The worst type of dishonor.
How are you going to talk shit about Kobe Beef, man? Or Wagyu?
Look, whatever his last name was, he was not that good of a basketball player.
Not that good of a pilot, either.
Not that good of a pilot at all.
He wasn't piloting the goddamn thing.
Well, then he guess he should have been a better pilot.
It's true. Then maybe he could have.
Yeah.
It's late on the East Coast. Yeah.
2:30 almost.
2:22. Yeah.
Oh God, it's after midnight for me.
Oh yeah. Holy shit.
How could you ever function, sir?
No, I got like normal dude hours recently. Like before I was bitching about having like a regular dude job. No, I'm at work at 10 now.
Oh fuck. Like,
AM, there's two of them sons of bitches.
Right. When did they add another one?
I work 11:30 to, well, 8 technically, but 11:30 to 7:30.
I don't want to dox you, Jason, but like on a serious question, what do you do for a living?
I work in shipping. I work at a company that makes heat transfers for shirts. They make banners and stuff. They handle the official merchandise for the NFL for like the numbers and the names on the back of the jerseys and stuff like that.
Say no more. I actually know who that is. So yeah.
It's fine. But yeah, I just work in the shipping department though. So that's how like if I do the art auctions, I'm always like, yeah, $6 shipping because I just ship it from my work usually. And we
game in the system. I love it.
Yeah, I can manually ship stuff out through my work. So and you know, my company doesn't care as long as I'm done. We're done, like the end of the day, and we're done with everything, and I could just ship it out then at the end of the day and you know, help people save on shipping costs in that regard. So
yeah. See, Edwin's got it. Jason is just a humble importer exporter. He is not the kingpin of crime at all.
Yeah, pretty much. Yeah. People want me to be though.
I mean, that wasn't entirely what he said. I kind of read into it, but you know.
I'm gonna go with what you said, Wolverine. I like it.
I think it's better. Yeah.
Yeah. I'm gonna see what he said. I'm gonna look.
Nah, not worth it.
What's a chat anyway?
It's a silly thing.
But it's a silly place. Yeah, let's not go there.
You know, I do like that it's a little bit more of a physical job. I'm not sitting still. Serena, sit down and draw afterwards all the time. Mm-hmm. So, and I do try to go to the gym or work out 3 days a week. So,
Dean, I have given up the ways of the heister, yet I am still certified.
When do you start coloring this?
Hey, Dean, send me the link for the video you're talking about. Because when I look it up, your channel's weird. Like, struck. The information it's showing.
Does Dean not have a wrench?
Yeah, Dean has a wrench.
Just drop it in
chat. Pretty sure Dean has a wrench.
All I have open is StreamYard. That's too difficult.
Oh, yeah, you got a good point. Just set it in Twitter. He can open that tab.
No, when I went...
Or shots. To
his channel, it like literally shows, it says no views on every one of his videos.
Oh, that checks out.
No, like I've like nobody, I know, has, I've watched them. Views. Yeah.
Or have.
No, like whenever one pops up, I'll like usually get a notification and watch it. Like
I give Dean shit, but just I have for the like and the videos. View
at least, you know.
Sun's getting real low.
I'm just curious if there's something wrong with his channel.
Don't rub me like that, Jason.
Yeah, there's something wrong with his channel. It's on YouTube.
Oh no! If you open it up, it shows everything now.
Oh,
well, yeah, everything. I thought you had to pay extra for that.
Not with Dean.
Not with Dean. Yeah, it's a good point. Damn it.
Like Dean provides for his viewers.
When he says your mate down under, he means literally down under.
I gotta watch the last episode of Reacher.
No spoilers for season two, man. I need to.
Yeah, I have not started season two yet. I'm waiting for them all to drop so I can watch them all at once.
It's pretty wild when the xenomorph comes in. It's all
I saw that coming.
The nuns exploding is
yes. Fun.
Pretty wild stuff.
Like the way season one ended, they had to bring it in.
They had to.
There's nothing else. There's nowhere else to go except Reacher in space.
Yeah.
It's only logical.
Mm-hmm. I saw a parody comic of Reacher that was hilarious. Let me see if I can share it.
Was he in space?
No, but it was the dumbest thing. It was pretty clever.
Don't think about that sentence real careful.
The brand new ones from a couple hours ago. It needed to update.
Instead of going into channels I'm subscribed to, I searched Comics Mate, and there's like a landing page under his icon, and it says latest right. from Comics Mate, and all of that said zero views. I'm like, what the fuck? Because it was like the last 20 videos all said no views.
Yeah, sometimes it's easier to.
And like some were live streams that I was in the chat on. So I was like, what the hell?
Yeah, Dean is an AI bot. You're not wrong.
Yeah.
I mean, look at that icon. It's got to be an AI bot.
I know it's AI bot because I've seen it move. That's really him.
Jack Reach Around.
Oh, if it isn't called Jack Reach Around, they phoned it in. That's pretty good.
Yeah, I'll go with that. I am a yappy AI bot. That's true. You are.
That sweet, sweet Aussie AI bot.
I think Ryan has gone too far, but that's him.
Are you gonna show this? I'm gonna get going soon.
I'm still trying to find it.
Suspense.
Jason's my ride, so I got to leave when he leaves. No pressure, Jason.
God damn. Oh, it's all good. I'm going to leave in a couple minutes. You find
it? Why is that so fucking clever? And I'm pissed that I've never thought of it. God damn it.
I'm his boxing and shipping apprentice. So
that's right. I'm still in recovery from rotator cuff surgery, so he helps me lift the heavy boxes.
Yeah, that's wise.
Yeah, I rotate cups for him.
He does. It's a good cup rotation.
Yeah. Gets that full 90 degrees.
He gives great lobe.
Fuck you.
Star Trek reference for the week.
Hey, what's up, Mo?
Hey, Mo, how's it going? Oh, shit, no. No, you did not. Just drawing Bloodbone. Hanging out with Jason and Skip.
Mo Biggs is here?
Yeah.
It looks like it.
He leaves. He even cordially said hi to you, Skip. Holy crap. No snark, no nothing. It was hey, Skip. That's all it was. Skip lives in fear. Fear of a black avatar.
That's because it's black.
He'll know.
He's gone. He left.
I left? I gotta go.
Yours right.
Have a good one, Jason.
No, it's late. I gotta go. And
he's waiting. Yeah. He's waiting. He's waiting
and
in your car.
I can't be his ride, dude. I can't drive. He's my ride.
You agree.
There's no rule saying you can't.
I can't drive him home in one piece.
That's never mentioned that. No one said anything about how many pieces.
All right, I'm going to go get Skip home in a couple pieces. So
That's fair, yeah.
All right. I'll check you all later.
See you good, man.
Good one, Jason.
Peace.
Oh, goddamn.
Like, there's a law against it, but there's no rule.
Yeah. Laws are meant to be bent and challenged and envelope pushed. I found out a fun one the other day that lets me get to where I'm going nearly twice as fucking fast. And I found this out from a state trooper.
Not illegal to drive over open plains?
No. I'm talking about highway rules.
Oh, yeah.
If you're in the left lane, you can go up to 15 miles an hour over the posted speed limit, and as long as the purpose is to pass a vehicle.
That is the purpose of the lane.
Yeah. But, like, I didn't realize that, like, if there was a codified number, and there is.
I wouldn't have been able to tell you in a precise number. Mo's here was the safe word. Mo, I guess I won't have to skip the rest of the stream. Am I right?
Mo's here was the safe word.
Yeah.
Well, you have to give the ball gag back.
No, he can keep it, really.
Escape goating? What the fuck?
I don't know what that means.
Somebody done fucked all that. Oh, that must be a comment.
Or something. I don't know. It's Dean. It could be anything, really.
Now, Dean was noting that, like, based on his last short or video,
it's in my
comments. Everybody was calling him a Nazi.
He says it's in my comments, Michael.
Yeah, okay. See, called it.
There you go.
I am listening to Wolverine slowly get apoplexy while I draw.
There were only two things I really felt like, you know, I needed to drink more heavily for, and we fixed one, and you inked the other one.
Hear that, Edwin? It's committed.
It's driving me up the goddamn wall, but, you know, I'll cope. You can see the question in his hands.
There is no rank higher than Golden Wrench. At that point, you are simply God. Mm.
And Mo can still time you out.
Like, at that point, Mo could time himself out.
Only he could. Oh, there's the question. There's a question.
What's the question?
Can Mo time himself out? I was trying to phrase it more like, can God create a rock so heavy he can't lift it?
Is there a wrench so powerful? That...
Is there a wrench so powerful that even Mo can't time himself out? I just tried it. I can't. Mystery solved.
Wait, boop.
Boop?
Boop. Oh my God, there's this old dude on camera. Hey, what's up? And you're muted. Not on StreamYard. Must be on the headset.
What's up, fellas? Had to get Jason home.
When did Skip get here?
I've been here.
Didn't you missed your ride, man.
I haven't seen you in a while.
Why's my camera on? Got to fix that.
I don't know. It's in the back rooms giving secrets to Jason.
Was I? Let me check the private chat. I want to see what I said. Nothing.
More shots.
That's how secret it was.
Yeah. I was too busy pouring booze. I have no idea what secrets.
So, Michael, are you doing, are you using a cell phone for your camera, or what do you use?
This one?
Yeah.
No, this is my other actual webcam. I think it's only 720 or something like that, though. I'd have to check.
Is it on a bendy arm?
Yes, that's why it's now vibrating.
Yeah.
It's set to 480. Okay.
I bought one, and if I'm on a live stream, it like blurs out every time. So, but I can record using OBS, and it's fine. But it's on live streams, it's terrible.
Oh no!
It's that IP4K one.
That I think I can tell you why that happens, because it happens to me too. A lot of people, really. It probably wouldn't happen noticeably as much if it was your live stream.
No, on my own, it does.
Oh, even on yours? Okay.
Yeah.
If it was on other people's streams, then it would be because of the latency going from you to them or whatever and through, as opposed to just them who are the source.
Oops.
Oops. How did this happen?
Oh, no. What has happened? What did I do?
What have you done?
Mobig says, Skip, your camera is always blurring things out because you still have it set to PGCG. Yes, I do. Try to keep Comicsgate PG. Well, you guys saw what the last guy that went and tried to do some R-rated CG stuff, like, he got canceled, so.
I have no idea who that even would be at this point. There have been a few of them, and I've generally ignored most of them.
Right.
Is it the Dungeoneer stuff? Is that what you're talking about? Oh, okay.
Oh, well, I mean, that wasn't about... I mean, it was things they were doing, not like books. I thought you meant books.
Oh, no. I just got, like, the biggest omnibus I've ever bought in the mail today. Where do I put it?
Okay.
I'll show you guys this thing. This is my favorite comic ever, but I haven't read the whole thing. Probably only read about 20 issues. Turn the camera back on. So I found this on eBay.
Dear Penthouse, this has never happened to me before.
No, it's Stray Bullets, the Uber Alice edition. But look how fat this thing is. It's 1,300 pages.
That is large.
Christ, yeah. You could kill a man with that.
Yeah, on Amazon, it's $43 shipped. But yeah, it's the whole collected black and white comic. But biggest damn thing, right?
Yeah.
Like the spine's just gonna break on it because it's just a paperback. It's just gonna like
crumble. Spine's not strong enough to support its own weight. Silvar, that is fucking brutal. And you should think about what you just said.
Well, I wasn't supposed to appear on camera because like I've been wearing a hat all day and didn't brush my fucking hair before I went live.
Silver says that's a big coloring book. It's a black and white comic. I get it. That was mean.
Hey, you're free than that.
Oh, shit. LDG, what up? He doesn't like to be called Pickles, apparently. I mean, that's how the fans know you. That's a sign of love, man. And one day, that man will free the net. See, I'll do one skull on a costume. I'm not going to pull that Bancroft shit of doing a whole goddamn catacombs.
That would be derivative.
Like that was, I will give this to Bancroft. He tackles some of the most insane pieces.
I'll give you that.
Like, I think he does them and does them so well only because he doesn't know enough to know that he's not supposed to do them.
That could be. That could be. He has not figured out that he can't do that yet, so he's still working it.
He doesn't know that he can't do it, so he just does it.
Yeah. So far, that may be like you can put like Rankin Bass Legolas on the table, but like none of us can forget that Rankin Bass Aragorn was basically just a fucking Cro-Magnon.
Looked like one of the Mormons from that fucking video they put out. You know which one. And if you are of dark skin and believe enough in the Lord, your skin will sufficiently lighten to allow passage to heaven.
Oh, holy shit. The Mormons do some weird stuff, man.
I, too, wish to go to planet Kolob to be judged so I can have my own planet of sex goddesses to populate.
Yes, yes. Don't forget, God is not actually God. God is just Adam.
Well, God's just a dude who had actual, you know, copulation with Mary.
Yeah, yeah. Like, I could be misremembering, but I do believe the God of Earth is Adam. Being the first man, you see. This is the planet he got.
I don't know about that one specifically.
Or something to that effect.
I cannot say one way or the other. I do not have definition on that. So what was it like giving a virgin birth? Yeah, Mary, what was that like? Jesus. Exactly.
Oh, no, I might be thinking of Bakshi. I think I am thinking of Bakshi. I was thinking of Bakshi for all this from the start. You said Rankin Bass. My brain went Bakshi.
Oh, shit, I forgot Rankin Bass did that.
I can't even remember.
Okay, I was thinking Bakshi too. Holy shit.
There you go. Skip over here trying to shame me like as if his will is stronger than mine.
I quit paying attention after you guys said Michael Bancroft.
That's fair. In no way am I implying that these boots should be canonical, but I like them.
Look, I see nothing from the knee down, so we can't prove they're not. Well, maybe the top might be, probably aren't, because we can, you know, I can see at least the top of one knee, but yeah, the rest, you know, you can't prove it.
They're right here. So they're right here.
No, I mean on the Shelby piece.
Oh, yeah.
The reference thing that I...
Well, and I think on the other one that he did, you can't see below that either.
So the top of those boots, clearly not canonical, but everything else, you can't prove it's not.
Edwin's going to be like fucking in DMs with Donal right now, being like, we need to change his boots.
They went back to Rankin Bass for Return of the King. That's how we got where there's a wit. There's a wit.
You throwing shade at one of the finest musical numbers ever to grace fantasy?
I would hope not. Like, I would dare say there is no musical piece in fantasy that has done half the work that that song has. Or seen use in nearly as many communities. Many walks of life find identification in this song.
Oh no, I've made a mistake.
Oh no.
I was waiting for you to say one.
I was listening for the slow clap. It's all I'm here for.
I had arguably better versions of that joke, but I refrained. I don't remember what they are, because now all I remember is one. But
it's about the quick draw, Wolverine. You gotta...
Right, yeah. Sometimes it is.
I'm going to mute myself for a minute. I got to go grab a brush.
Yeah.
Thank you. Not. I mean, yeah, go ahead.
Mute that shit.
Motherfucker.
I don't want to go to war today.
But I wonder why Skip doesn't stream so often. Day, day, day.
Ah, well, you know, it's a mystery. Who knows?
I was going to say, are you doing Mario? You just made me fuck up these teeth.
I've been drifting somewhere in the middle, not quite on anything, but I finally just gave up and let that happen. It was better than Elmo's World or Menomina. Like, it could have become any of those things.
Holy shit. Why? Why did you remind me that Elmo's World was a thing? Fuck, you did the voice too. Go directly to hell. Do not pass go. Do not collect $200.
Before I spent like 20 years just abusing my entire respiratory system, I used to be pretty spot on with the voices. Not very good at it anymore. But I used to be a vocal mimic. I enjoyed it. I used to pick up accents on accident, which got me into no end of trouble.
Yeah, I've kind of lost my ability to do that.
I have too. Like when I was in grade school, one of my uncles, who I almost never saw, like very few times, we went over to his place one, I think, Thanksgiving or some shit. I don't know why we didn't like him. None of us, but that happened. But he had married a deaf woman.
Oh, God.
And I had never met her before. And so, like, in the first few minutes, like, without even me knowing it, I had started talking like this. And I got my shit beat in. And I had no idea why.
Rightly so.
Everybody's like, don't mock her. I'm like, what?
God damn it. What was the name of that deaf actress that was, like, marginally hot? Marley Matlin.
Yeah. God damn it. I was right up on it, and then my brain went, no, all you're getting is Macaulay Culkin.
Sorry, we're out of that today.
We completely know what file you're referencing, but this is what you get.
One of my coworkers is deaf, and I like to walk around talking with my hand over his mouth, or over my mouth, so he can't read my lips. He's like, stop telling secrets!
Can you imagine how shitty it must be to have been a deaf person during COVID working?
I know a few that were heavily bitching about that, actually.
Right? Look, I don't know if this whole thing is valid or not. All I'm saying is I'm suddenly twice deaf.
I'm deafer.
I'm more deaf than I ever was before. Thank you, Fox.
Well, freaking the only place that even tried to enforce mask wearing where I live was Walmart.
Oh, I mean, that tracks.
It's a classy Thanks, place.
Boy.
Freaking around here, it was like, yeah, I'm just going to work. Fuck this.
I can't tell you how stupid it. I was far older than I should have been when I found out that, like, Walmart was founded by the Waltons.
See, my mom actually did some work for Sam back when he was alive. She was a hospice caretaker.
That shit blew my mind. I'm like, no.
See, like,
what happened to them? I remember they were like one of the richest families in the world, but you never hear about them. Like, did Bezos and Elon just take over and no one?
I mean, Walmart's still doing really well, though.
Yeah, by fucking over their employees for the most part, but yeah.
I mean, if it works. Do what you're good at, you know? The masks caused a bunch of children to suffer arrested development because they couldn't see mom's face to imitate it. Yeah, I'll buy that, yeah.
You know, especially by the people that, like, I know people around here, and guess what? They're implants. Freaking, that still wear masks.
Yeah, you see them at the store all the time still.
And, like, you know, one time a guy was like, oh, no, I've got something and I don't want to give it to everybody else. I was like, okay, that's fair.
Yeah. Like, I had to begrudgingly, like not be grumpy about my daughter's, like happiness over the whole thing. Over the whole mask thing. You know, I'm like, I'm sitting there, like, explaining, like just straight out, why there is absolutely no chance, even in science fiction, that this mask is helping fuck all. And she points out, yeah, but I kind of like it because, like, you know, my social anxiety. I'm like, I can't argue that.
See, like, if you actually have a logical reason, I'll allow it.
Right? I'm like, but it's dumb, though. She's like, yeah, but whatever, though.
Which is the only valid response to, it's dumb.
Yeah, pretty much.
You have a Rumble Roo Comics here.
Hey, Rumble, what's up? He has a real name, but I forget what it is. Richard, that's it.
I think you just made that up because of all those R's.
I was thinking the same thing.
Ooh, yeah, Dean, that's a good point from Jason.
What?
I'm reading a totally different chat. Never mind, guys.
God damn you.
What show are you watching? I want to go.
Right? It's backroom Whisper Network shit. You don't need to know.
Ah, look at this motherfucker. You know what? You have this coming.
What? Which part now?
And, like, it's not like it's nearly as bad as the "it looks like a muscle" figure in the comment. So, you have done an excellent version of the 1982 Hanna-Barbera Saturday morning cartoon version of this character.
Fuck yeah, I'll take it. I'm down with that.
Like, this was on NBC, and this is an animation still from it.
You hear that, Edwin? You're going to be on Saturday morning cartoons. This is the first animation cell right here.
Right here.
I like it. It looks like if Grifter and He-Man had a kid together.
We mentioned earlier, what if Hulk forced Grifter to have a child?
There are some He-Man legs, including the tiny little feet.
Those are not tiny little feet.
They really are, though.
Hey, at least I put feet on there, right, Rob Liefeld? Or Shelby Robertson?
Clayton Barton?
At least Shelby doesn't draw feet either. Him.
This is Shelby's art, I think. Yeah, this is Shelby's
your art.
Or, I mean, no. Okay, the reference that I'm using is Shelby's. Yeah. I forgot Skip can't see it. Goddamn, here, I'll share.
What is quick. Is that a tree or a beard?
Yes. Yeah, that's what I'm referencing. It's tree beard.
It's a mask.
No, I mean, what you're doing. Is that a tree or a
beach? Oh, it's a tree.
Okay, that's an interesting.
I'll move my hand here in a minute.
For a tree.
But yeah, this is the image I've been like basing on.
Yeah, that's the reference he's using.
Yeah, no feet. Dork.
I'm practicing my foggy ankles technique to get that 90s nostalgia. C and COH, that's easy. You just have one of those travel auras.
For real. Prestige power slide, yo.
Solomon Grundy want pants too.
Jeez, Scoob. I never understood the face cape as a superhero costume.
Strong wind, yeah.
It doesn't work the way almost everybody does it. But if you do it right, it's a very interesting kind of thing, and has historical precedence for actually existing.
Yeah, but that was like the plague.
I mean, even some versions of Zorro had a face cape mask.
Is Bloodbone a masker? Is that what I'm hearing here?
Really early movie version of Zorro had one of those masks.
Might have been Zorro the Gay Boy had one, but it was lace.
That works differently though. And like, no one's actually allowed to say anything bad about Zorro the Gay Blade because it was awesome.
It was.
Two cents, 3 cents, 4 cents a peso. Everyone for Zorro, stand up and say so.
I can't believe you just straight up fucking quoted that.
I probably haven't seen it in at least 30 years.
Like, no irony, no shame. None whatsoever.
If George Harrison could do it, I can do it. Like that particular sort of role wasn't, as I recall, exactly in George Harrison's oeuvre. But he owned that shit.
And now I coloring book this fucker.
Prestige Power Sprint. Prestige Power Slide is free. It is now. Let's see. It's like a lady man's bandana. Lazy man's, not lady. Lazy man's bandana. No, bandanas are much, much gayer than any face cape was ever, Pips has ever been. Unless it was drawn in a very 90s style that wasn't Jim Lee, in which case it was gay as fuck.
Yeah, originally this character had like a bishop neckerchief. Yeah.
I like that version of him is so much cooler than the one in City of Heroes. He looks all Native American and shit.
Well, I mean, and he's supposed to. Like in City of Heroes, you can't really get that going. Like, not without really, being like
he looks really bland as fuck in City of Heroes. He's much more interesting there. He was yellow like a banana. He was purple like a grape. What the fuck, Silva? Wolverine, CG's George Harrison. I'll take that shit. George Harrison was one of the last great, look, it doesn't even matter if I'm gay. I'm swimming in pussy. I may drown from all this tang. Please don't send help. colors were lines from Zorro the Gatelight, were they? I know he had like a whole like fucking rainbow Batman assorted suit of colors, and it was weird.
You know, I know canonically there was a reason that Batman did that.
There was.
And I remember the reason. I'm not going to go into it, but it was still stupid.
It was dumb.
It was like Quiltman, wasn't it?
No.
No, it was a guy that was using color to hypnotize people or something like that, and he was wearing different colors.
Didn't it have something to do with he had become rainbow striped because he had become magnetized or some stupid shit?
No, he had gone through each color individually first. There was like a red Batman, a yellow Batman, a blue Batman, a green Batman. He did them all. And then the rainbow one was when he went to go fight the actual villain.
I know. Maybe I'm thinking of the zebra suit, not the colored suit, the rainbow suits. Yeah, that was a different story.
Like, I used to think, like, Batman the Animated Series doing its merchandising line was, like, going a little crazy with the suits, and then I looked back in Golden Age, and I'm like, never mind, I'm an idiot.
I no one ever said, like, the Golden Age had good stories. It did not.
He fires smaller Supermans.
And to be fair, the Golden Age stories, pretty fucking good if you compare them to the Silver Age stories. There are no coherent Silver Age comic stories. Like the 60s and the 50s were kind of fucked. You fire smaller Superman. Yeah, exactly. Oh, look. What? Superman is killing his friends again to teach them a lesson.
Oh, in that issue of Superman, was his mom hot? Sweater.
In the Silver Age? No. She's definitely not. She's a little old lady.
Who do you think got hot first, Superman's mom or Aunt May?
Aunt May never got hot.
Superman's mom.
In the movies she did, though.
I figured it was clear he was not talking about the comics.
Okay.
Superman's mom did it first.
God, what the fuck is up with Aunt May? She's had two different fucking romantic storylines with two different goddamn Spider-Man villains, Doc Ock and goddamn Norman Osborn. What the actual fuck?
Look, it's clear in the comics that Aunt May has been kind of senile for like 70 years now.
She's got a really weak heart.
The bitch she's just a husk, really.
Well, and she's mostly blind. By the way, what is Norman Osborn's fucking hairdo supposed to look like in real life?
I can answer that if I can find a reference picture. I know exactly what it is, and it's drawn pretty much spot on.
Like fucking Norman and Harry got like that, you know, that in 70s and 80s and earlier. Fucking there. Like, I get that there was like a texturing thing supposed to be going on. It was supposed to be like tight waves.
But kind of.
I've never seen a live action version of that hairstyle.
At one point, I used to have somewhat ready access to two pictures of guys back at the time who had it, but I can't remember any names, so I'm kind of searching blind here.
Skank May. That was the issue of Superman when he beats Dracula with a helium balloon. So she knew he was Spider-Man all along and just didn't say anything. See, no, the issue where she found out the first time, I guess, was actually a really cool cover on that. Because it's like she catches him in the room or anything like that. She goes to do laundry and he had like haphazardly thrown his Spider-Man mask in it.
Yeah.
How about pink kryptonite, Rumble? Where all of a sudden Clark got very interested in interior decorating and male wardrobe.
There you go. Sharing. It's that.
I have to full screen that. Yeah. Oh my God, it's a real thing.
Uh-huh.
Skip, look at this fucking bullshit.
It's awesome. Like Kevin James got a perm.
But seeing it actually on someone in real life, it's like, yeah, that's exactly how you should draw.
No, that is a local newscaster who's been me too'd.
It's like looking at how fucking Romita Drew is. Like, yeah, that's pretty much it. I never would have been able to imagine what that would look like in real life, but that's spot on. I wish the actual picture I had here was bigger. See it better.
Oh, god damn it. I need some actual fucking flesh tones.
Just do it black and white, man. Uncolor it.
Edwin wants it colored.
Tell him that all the best stuff's in black and white.
He's a slave driver.
Tell him all the best stuff's in black and white, like manga.
Good God.
Which alcohol markers should I be fucking using? Oh, that one kind of works, but the tip is a little borked.
I ain't saying shit.
Smells nice, though. Hey, that's all right.
That's right. Here we slave driver. Here we are back at where there's a whip. Chris says you have flesh tones.
I mean, kind of. Like, this is one of those times where it just really be handy if fucking Copic or, you know, whoever just came out with like what Crayola did. And just be like, oh, the colors of the world. And it's just a whole bunch of actual natural skin tones.
Yeah. Is that marker as dry as it looks and sounds?
What the fuck? Oh, Jesus Christ, woman. Sorry. You fucking monster. Sneak into this office behind. What the hell?
If only she had done that while you were inking.
If she'd done that while I was inking, you'd have more to bitch about. Sorry. Human, so far. Human. One day, I shall rearrange my art desk and have shit where it's supposed to be again. Oh, look, Sharpies. That'll work.
If you're drawing Mo, yeah.
Sorry. I was trying to help you find your flesh. You had a whole case of flesh tones. I know you did. I remember buying them. I just don't know where you put them.
I don't know.
I thought they were in this drawer.
But the thing you don't do is come in and scare the shit out of somebody.
Ask her if it's in a box that says Colors of the World.
Go away. I love you too.
I love you, you shithead. Fuck out of here. Oh no, that's Sister Slay, Rumble. Oh, god damn it.
So you're drawing a Powerpuff Girls book, huh?
Somebody started doing
Actually, no, that would be Kids Next Door. Sorry.
Some next gen version of Powerpuff Girls. Like they had kids and shit.
Yeah, that's weird. Not as weird as that TV show they were going to do, where they were all basically whores.
Oh, the live action one.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah.
Did you change markers from the neck to the arm?
No.
Okay.
I flipped ends.
It just looks a different. Okay, because it looks like a different tone.
It's one of those.
Are they different?
It's artist loft, so it's not awesome, but it's like the closest to like a natural Caucasian tone that I've got.
I've never been able to afford colored markers. I have no idea.
These are alcohol. These are poor man's Copics. These are like half the price of Copics.
Yeah, the best I've ever had is like, what's this fuck who makes crayons?
Crayola?
Yes.
Wait, Crayola makes alcohol markers?
No, not that I know of. I just mean the ones in the grocery store, you know.
Oh, okay. Those are just the regular markers. Okay.
That's the only markers I've ever had. Everything else has never been in my price range.
Well, my local Michaels was having like a really cool sale during tax season a couple of years ago, so I ended up getting a good set of Copics, but then there was a bunch of other stuff too. It was wild sale stuff. And so I spent about, I don't know, $300 and have like 100 alcohol markers, which is actually a really good deal because they're normally like 7-piece.
Yeah, I've been subjected to being in Michaels, so I've been able to like look at all the cool markers, but I've never been able to take one home.
Adopt a puppy now.
Silvar says, yes, I had Crayola alcohol markers. They dried up in half the time of dollar store markers. That's rough.
Oh, you just dip them in isopropyl alcohol again and they're good to go. I'm kidding. Don't do that.
I mean, in the short term, it works. Same thing for most any felt tip marker, really.
God, this is such uneven coverage.
You just need it to work like now for a few seconds.
That and it does. Nextdoor.
Exactly. That's clearly Father.
That and it does lighten up as it dries. Sometimes one must apply 2 coats.
At least, yeah. Hey, you genuine.
Hey, Dave, what's up?
Silver says, I tried the, quote, felt tips, unquote, disintegrated rapidly at that point. Like I said, if you just need them to work, like, right now. For a few seconds.
I heard pain. I'm working off the reference, man.
The wrapping wraps around the meat of the thumb.
Well, he's only got one joint in that thumb anyway, so.
Da-da-da-da-da.
It's like I was trying to go quickly so that I could. So there's gonna be some speed errors here.
Look, I'm dealing with these fucking markers up here.
No lie. Praline? What the fuck? The name's on these goddamn colors.
Well, how could it be any clearer? You know, praline.
You know, fucker, we're gonna make something up and see if it works. Mm-hmm. We'll do it live.
God damn. Rumble says, I got pins like Copics of a new off a new Chinese site that were around $9 for 60 and they work great. That's insanity.
Did they say Heisho in China?
What?
Something Shelby got a hold of. Mm. It was like, oh, you're not fooling me. Because Heisho is Spanish for made, which you see on products made in Mexico, Heisho in Mexico.
This one said
Heisho in China.
Look, oh, it's totally legit. They're just Mexicans who work in China. You know, like happens.
This is gayer by the moment.
Look, it's not upward progress, but it's steady.
Right?
Praline, 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 praline.
Oh, Christy's going to kill you for that. Jolene's like her favorite song.
Hey, Rumble typed it. I just did it.
All right, honey, you're going to have to boycott the Australians. Something Skip apparently did eons ago.
There you go.
I don't think I boycotted all of Australia, just everyone that I've met that's from there.
Not all of Australia, just all the ones you'd know.
Yeah.
Oh, honey, I found those colors of the world. No shit.
Nice. Just in time.
She was searching in exactly the right spot, too.
Fucking Silver. Holy fuck, I was thinking that while tabbed out.
Too bad I've moved on to red.
Right.
What the fuck color are you? I mean, I know what the label
says. You can't just ask what color it is.
Who is that, Huck Finn? Jeez.
Oh, yeah, Huck Finn and his older friend. What was his name again?
I think his name you can call... He said you can call me Jim. Huck was racist.
Look, Huck wasn't racist. He was just specific, okay? There's a lot of Jims in town. He got tired of people being like, what's Jim? He's like, no, let's just cover this from the fucking beginning, right? I want to be clear in my communication skills. The wife told you.
You didn't find him. Fuck off. I just turned around and there they were. I don't know why you were struggling so much. She's probably going to come back with something logical, like it's not my office.
Oh, I figured she'd just come with something, you know, with something solid like a frying pan. That is the gayest, pinkest red I have ever seen.
It's called geranium. What do you think?
Oh, well, then this is just your gay-ass choices in life.
Like, straight up, not one thing is just called red or dark red or...
Oh, shit. Oh, you gotta give Crayola that. They got red covered. Don't forget the red in the hair. Yes. Don't forget his danger hair.
Yeah, this weird fucking anti-rogue shit going on. God damn it, Edwin.
Yeah, it's like a shot going through the part. You wouldn't let me keep looking.
I mean, let you. You live here too. You could have just told me to fuck off and kept looking.
But you're emancipated.
Don't put this on me. What is this one called? Oh, it actually says deep yellow. Okay. Which is the most straightforward fucking marker name I have.
There you go. Silver, you might not be better than that, but I wish you were.
Shot through the partner. Fuck off. You go to hell. You go to hell and you die.
Appreciate his patience.
I don't think he realizes he's muted.
If I was doing what he's doing, I wouldn't either.
Oh god, he's straight up silhouetting.
No, it's the lines, dude.
There we go. There's something Shelby's doesn't have. You're welcome, Edwin. Pit hair.
Yeah. This blood bone doesn't shave his pits. Like a girl.
Praline.
I hadn't really fully expected to sing that when I started it, so I wasn't really prepared to hit the note on the last praline.
I did not prepare for this.
I didn't know. I put no forethought into it, and then I was just there.
I heard that. Wolverine just disconnected. He gave up. I understand. Or he's going to the bathroom.
Or that.
That no, what? Boop. What? Oh shit. How's it going, Xevious?
Oh, good morning. How are we doing, guys?
Doing all right.
Should I pop in? My voice is about halfway there, but you know, use it or lose it.
You just gave Silvar an opening for another Bon Jovi reference.
How's it going, Xevious?
Oops. There we go. How's my sound?
Other than the echo, awesome.
Yeah, it's going. Fixed it.
Fuck it, we'll do it live.
Hey, excellent, man.
Wolvo. So I've been following around for a bit here. I'm drawing stuff, too. So must be a Friday.
Must be.
Yeah. I'm thinking about bringing this back as like a weekly. And McMahon takes it back over again, because I know one day he will.
Yeah.
So I honestly don't know why I stopped.
That's good. So who are you drawing, Mike? I've been here for about an hour.
This is Bloodbone. This is Edwin, the guy who did the Ace, Edwin Acevedo.
Acevedo. Yeah.
Yeah, this is his latest campaign and property. Mm-hmm. I'm working off a reference done by Shelby Robertson.
Cool. Looking good.
That just bleeds 90s.
It does.
But that's Shelby, dude. Shelby, like, he was a ghost artist for Liefeld, so that just says everything you need to say.
Yeah, yeah. But we like him anyway.
I got a feeling, Wolvo, do you like Liefeld or no?
No.
He's an okay dude.
Yeah.
I wouldn't even go that far.
Yeah.
I don't think I've heard an okay dude story about Liefeld, like, ever.
Mm-hmm. I don't know, I follow him on Twitter and he says some funny fucking shit.
Hmm. I think a couple times probably. Yeah.
So, hey, you got those proportions and the anatomy right, Michael?
Oh, of course I do. Wolverine has been nothing but glowing support throughout this whole process.
Good. Yeah.
I barely said shit.
See? Yeah. That's what I mean.
Just watch out. You don't want Mike Miller doing a draw over on you.
You understand, when the Council of Mikes becomes a thing, and it will become a thing, he is the final boss of the Council of Mikes.
Yeah. He's there.
The Council of Mikes does include myself, McMahon, Bancroft, a few others.
Look, at the end of the day, I'm 5'6". Like, Mike wants to step to this shit, I will cunt punch that little chihuahua motherfucker. If anyone's going to do a draw over, it's me.
Oh. Yeah. Cool. Yeah, I just tweeted a bit ago. I don't think we need accurate anatomy in comics for the most part.
Why do you hurt me?
Wolverine's eyebrow just twitched off of his head.
Why do you hurt me?
Just clean off. Just
yeah. Yeah, fair enough.
Yes, Rumble Roo, 5'6".
Wait, who's 5'6"?
Me.
Wow.
But he will still cunt punt.
Yeah, yeah, I will cunt punt that little chihuahua motherfucker. But we are all allotted to begin with a certain amount of bodily mass. I allotted mine more wisely.
Yeah. What? Silver's got to be 6'1", 6'2", hey?
Who, Silver?
I don't know.
Sounds valid enough. I don't know.
No, I said Senor.
There you go, Silver. You are now canonically 6'1".
Senor?
And he's like, son of a bitch, I was 6'4". Holy shit, is it really 1:30 in the morning?
3:32.
Wow.
God damn. I've been having fun with this piece. It's not awesome, but I like it. It looks like shit, like the newer gens of like Streets of Rage. In sure. Final Fight. It looks like a sprite for that, and I'm okay with that.
Silver says, nope, I'm still 6'6".
Oh shit. None of us knew. Either if you had said something before, we did not pay attention.
Dyscalculia does not remember numbers.
So, Michael, you're working. Skip, you got a thing on the go. Looks good.
Skip, you've met Exevious, right?
Guys, I'm sorry. I forgot I was on the stream. I thought I was just listening. Hey, Exevious, how are you?
Yeah.
Not bad, man. My voice is gone, but I'm going to give it a shot.
I'm getting over a cold myself. I've been drinking NyQuil all day, I'm not really...
Michael, you realize now Skip has made a when did Skip get here joke. On accident.
He gay kept himself.
You've been like here from the beginning, Skip. Fuck.
Man, I wish I knew. I had some really, really ripping one-liners.
Yeah. Shame.
Damn shame.
Like... When the Council of Michaels takes charge, the last man standing is going to be Wolverine in a pair of dirty underwear holding a gallon of water over your guys' corpses.
Why am I involved with the Council of Michaels?
So you're going to take them. You're going to take them all out.
Why would you do that? We are a force for good. We're a force for change, whether you want it or not.
Someone has to pay someone to do that.
I thought Smiller was only like 5'1".
I don't know.
Possible.
I think that's about right. 5'1".
Yeah. I heard somewhere that his wife's like a foot taller than him.
Oh, like he could barely reach into that fucking tree.
I forgot all about that. I've still never tried that fruit either.
Nobody wants them.
A kumquat?
Yeah.
A loquat.
Yeah. Nothing to write home about. It's one of those weird things like starfruit. You know, it's like, okay.
Starfruit's very interesting, but at some point you're like, okay, I've been there, I've done that.
Yeah. It's kind of, you know, it's like touristy stuff. Okay. I had it.
Yeah. It's a dragon fruit and shit like that. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, I'm old school. Like, did a grocery order today. Oranges, apples, pears, bananas. It's good.
Oh, my.
Apples, peaches, pumpkin pie.
Yeah. Yeah, exactly.
I hope you're actually rolling with that and not just rolling that out.
I'm definitely rolling with it. Apples, peaches, pumpkin pie.
It's a good song. If anyone was going to ask me, I know what the fuck I was talking about. I hope it was you.
I thought you were talking about the Fruit of the Loom logo.
See?
Milk, milk, lemonade?
Yeah, what's in the Fruit of the Loom logo?
Apples, oranges, pumpkin pie?
No.
Okay. Pull it up.
Apples, peaches, pumpkin pie.
Oh. There's a good one. Wow.
I'm just making these colors up as I fucking go.
The so boots are. You're using half price Copics. I get it. What's what brand is that?
This the two different ones. I've got Master's Touch, and you're gonna choke a little bit when I say Artist Loft.
No, that's fine. Copics are bloody expensive.
I do have Copics. I've got a bunch of different alcohol markers. Just
and as fate would have it, he has a Colors of the World, the whole set that he didn't use.
Yeah. But like I tend to hoard my good supplies.
Oh fuck yeah.
Yeah.
Like I have good supplies I got when I was a teenager I still haven't used.
Well, you'll be shit out of luck if you're talking markers, right?
Oh no, none of them are markers.
Yeah.
You guys should look on a Mercari for your art supplies. They're probably stolen, but you can get some really good deals.
I mean, fair.
Well, okay, so I was using nothing but Rapidograph pens last year, and they're about $25 a pop, and the replacement nibs around 15.
Jesus.
And on Mercari, I was finding 10 pen sets for about $40.
Jesus.
So wow. I'm just saying.
Still way out of my price range.
And you bought them? They're the same thing, right?
Yeah, like they're great. It's just they're the most temperamental pens I ever used. So,
so he challenged himself, and he would be the one to tame them.
I did that for years. That's a lot of work. I remember, like when I was in school, it'd be the cool kids who got the ultrasonic cleaner, huh?
Yeah, someone recommended that, so I bought one, and it's just. If the ink dries inside of the barrel, yeah. It just snaps that little wire that the ink feeds on, and it's done.
Yeah, exactly. But there's nothing worse than, like, you know, going for a pen at 3 in the morning, and it's bogged down.
Yeah, they're fun to use while they lasted, but... Like this is one right here. Let's see if it works. Oh no, this one still works.
That was the rest of the rhyme. Milk, milk, lemonade, round the back the fudge is made. There it is. I knew I could remember it.
Silver says, looks like Skip just inked one of the 22 panels that always work. I don't trace 3D models. I trace Wally Wood.
It's what he would have wanted.
I mean, if you're going to trace, yeah.
He literally told you to.
Hey, Dillard's here. Heard any good stories about Dillard lately?
How you doing, Dillard? Every show's about you, which means every show's about Chrome Dog.
Dillard owns 40% of this show.
Yeah, take that to the bank.
I mean, 40% of his appearances have generated 40% of his sales. So.
Yeah. He shits 40% of Chrome Dog every day.
God, I've been off Twitter for a few hours. Is everybody still arguing about the same shit from yesterday?
Oh yeah,
Probably.
That bone's not going to get old until Ethan's viewership numbers start dropping.
His numbers aren't going to drop based on that. He's too
good. His numbers are still going up though.
That's good. No,
I don't think that shit's going to stop until Eric shuts the fuck up. So you know, like never.
I don't know, I tuned into his critique of Isom Book 2.
Wasn't as good as the first one. The critique, that is. Like, the book was absolute fucking rat trash, but the critique wasn't as good.
Yeah.
I thought.
No, I tuned out after about half an hour. It wasn't, yeah. It was,
He wasn't doing art school. He was just losing his fucking mind.
Yeah. And I would say that because I did watch the, I watched the whole book one critique a few days ago.
Much better critique.
It was a pretty good critique.
Yeah.
Like, you know, he's actually talking about camera angles.
And, yeah, people have actually learned things. That was cool. Like that. Yeah.
Yep.
Which I was hoping the second one would be, but like he couldn't take it.
The backgrounds, what there are of them, are so goddamn bland.
All the images
look fucking flat and static as fuck.
If nothing else, I can describe Isom issue 2 real simple. It's Shades of Blue, the comic.
It's crap. A lot of the old critic show with John.
I swear to God, every page is basically just Shades of Blue.
Now, is that Gabe Al-Tayeb as well?
Yeah, last I knew, as far as I know.
See, that surprised me. Like he's
Dillard, you're going to bring quality to this shit, right?
Because Gabe's a vet with a lot of cool stuff behind him. I know that.
He's a vet. I don't know how like good he is of a vet.
Well, I think he was DC for a few years. I mean, that's, you know, it's all whatever. But
I mean, yeah, but like, I don't know if he was. I don't know if I'd say he was like great. like I remember seeing like stuff he'd done before he came to CG and stuff he was doing while he was here, and I don't remember being impressed.
Yeah, I'd have to see more than Isom, because Isom is, it's a lot of the same, just daylight, sunny, you know, blue skies.
And no background to speak of, yeah. Which is a good job if you can get it. Yeah. I want you to draw practically no backgrounds. Oh no, I must protest.
You know, the conversation, you guys might have caught this, but if you go way back, like, I used to watch your boy Zach.
I'm sorry.
And I used to watch, you know, Richard Meyer, your boy Zach. Yeah. You know, his little critiques. And there was one where he pulled out it was a Batman comic. There's like a little silhouette of Batman.
And it had his dick in it.
Yeah. And he had no pants on. But it was a usual and it probably would have been a current release, let's say 4 years ago. Mm. It had Batman on the skyline. And then he kind of pulls back to the camera and he's like, now you'll notice that the entire city is a photocopy of a photograph. And that's it.
Yeah.
And then his take was, he's like, but you know what? Rule of cool. He's like, I kind of dig it. I was like, yeah, you know.
There have probably been a good 3 or 4 times in comic history where that's been a decent choice.
Yeah.
Maybe. I think all of those were in the like 60s.
can you think of one? Because I was trying to find that Batman
comic. I can remember remembering them, but I can't remember like anything specific about like what they were or where they're from.
Gotcha.
Because it means like just a straight up fucking, that's a photo in black and white usually. I mean, it has never been something that's been done often, really.
Yeah.
So, I mean, there can't be that many examples.
Yeah.
Like, I'm sure it was probably done, at least once or twice or something in Fantastic Four, maybe once in Superman. I'm not sure.
All the time in the Ultimate Marvel stuff.
Sure.
Because they were, like, using, oh, this is in Dubai. So they just, like, literally traced or photocopied a picture of the skyline of Dubai or some shit.
I mean, a trace over is like I'm talking about like that is literally just a photograph they statted in.
Oh yeah, I saw that. Like, here's a photograph and with a couple filters on it.
Oh, I mean like from the 60s, so there was no such thing as filters.
Oh, back then, no, I didn't
see that
much. Yeah,
and it's like, oh look, dot shading on a photograph.
Well, like, I mean, in the 60s, well, prior to Photoshop, actually. Getting a really good black and white image to look like line art was about as much work as actually just drawing the damn thing.
Yeah, like the ones I'm partially thinking of, like there was no even attempt at line art. It's just here's a photo.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, but like, I mean, I did. I studied old school photography too.
Yeah.
And back in the day, that was called PMT, or a photo mechanical transfer.
Oh, nice.
So you can shoot it through all kinds of different halftone screens if you want.
Yeah.
But then your exposure, setting your white point and your black point, that's just a slider in Photoshop.
Huh.
But if you actually got a box with mechanicals and negatives, you got to do a lot wrong to get one that's right.
Hmm.
Yeah, shit, just picture a good album cover from 60s, 70s, 50s even.
Yeah.
Where it's just black and white. No real gray. That's a shitload of work to get it to look good.
Wow. Uh-huh.
Nowadays, you just desaturate and up the contrast.
Right.
Yep. Pretty much.
Brighten.
Sorry, I sound.
That's actually probably a much more complex equation than it seems like it is on the surface so far. I could throw all kinds of variables into that question. It's a little broad. Then again, I also have more of a buzz from like this whiskey than I expected to have. Clearly, I have not eaten in a while, and I know what I'll be doing after the stream.
It's another boop.
It's a boop?
It is a boop. A boop. Welcome, Dillard.
It's a bibbidi bobbidi boop.
What you doing? I see an eyeball.
I'm drawing a crab.
Is that Sebastian?
It is Sebastian, yeah.
Oh, shit.
Instead of that big old long, I gave him a steak knife instead of a butcher knife.
It's a one-handed light weapon, so he can get his finesse feet with it.
Yeah.
This way he can also carry a shield. You know?
Yeah, he can backstab.
Yeah, dude. I thought his weapon was attached to his arm, isn't it?
Yeah, it is. I have it. Well, not attached. It's like tied on.
Yeah, like duct tape or some shit. Yeah. Maybe that one fell out of the tape and he just jammed this one in.
That was my favorite part of that Child's Play movie where Chucky just sticks that knife into his wrist. Oh, it's great. Duct tapes it up. Give me the power, I beg of you.
Dumbala.
Yeah, that's pretty detailed. What are you using for a reference on that?
He sent me some pictures on Twitter. Oh, my DMs.
Dillard just has a crab stapled to his wall.
Yeah.
Dude, crabs are great. You can draw them all as crazy as you fucking want. It still looks like a crab.
That's because everything evolves into crabs.
There you go.
Crabby. Yeah, I just sketched it out. It looks enough like a crab. And, you know, when you're doing these, basically he's a monster, right? So when you're drawing monsters, you don't got to be real. I don't got to use a digital asset.
Nope. Don't have to download.
No 3D tracing here.
Oh, funny. Man. Yellow flash book I'm working on. 3D tracing everywhere.
Trace all day, every day.
Clipped that.
I don't be giving a fuck.
I should call it before I overdo it. Hold on a second. One more. Hold on. One more color.
So, who is this character?
This is Bloodbone from Edwin Azevedo, the guy who made the ace.
Mm. Yep. Hey, you, TJ. How you doing?
Hey, TJ. Got a, I'm up late enough for the English folk to invade. To try to invade again? What the hell?
How's that progress going, TJ?
It's a stream of 1812. What the fuck?
So what'd you think of Panatra's new song?
Ooh.
The Big Bad Booty Daddy?
Mm-hmm.
It was actually kind of cute. I liked it.
I've been humming it to myself for about an hour and a half now.
Yeah, I heard that. Is it good?
I was drawing a butt earlier too, and I was like, "Big fat booty, daddy, booty, booty, booty."
So, was that an Eric sample or what?
Yeah. I presumed it was.
Yeah.
Eric July was throwing a fit.
Yeah.
He was like, what are you talking about? My criticism. My criticism. What you worried about, Ethan? You're supposed to be the big bad booty daddy, ain't you?
Then he pulls a Fred Sanford and falls out of the chair.
Yeah, he's like, oh, but my criticism. Oh. Grabs his heart, falls out. Oh,
I'm coming, Elizabeth. It's the big one.
This is hilarious.
Yes, it's stupid o'clock in the morning on a Saturday.
Yeah, these are the jokes, folks. Chocolate or cinnamon?
I mean, it was an attempt so far. It failed, but it was an attempt.
Oh, it was funny. That shit was funny.
I wouldn't agree.
Yeah, but you hate everything, bro. Mm-hmm.
It says so in your byline.
It's true. No, it says
you're contractually obligated.
Tired of everything. I hate most shit. Like, I think somebody could have done that funny. I just don't think he did.
He did the...
Hello, Angela.
Hey, Angela.
She was talking to me. This gents, not cads.
I am a cad, sir.
Yeah, like, didn't he do that for the AOC thing, like, last year?
I know somebody did a song. I don't know if Contra had anything to do with it.
I think that was it.
Because I would have swore the one I'm thinking of I saw in a lot more circles than CG.
Did you see the one where she was dancing on a rooftop and big old huge mommy milkers just bouncing around in that little tight t-shirt?
I do recall that vividly.
Mm-hmm. I don't recall that. Can you pull it up?
Do not be tempted by a big socialist titties, Dillard.
I pull it up most times I watch it, Dillard, yes.
Yeah, she's all right.
No, she's not, but she was in that one video.
Like, still cover her face, yeah.
Yeah, Jewish space lasers, that's the video.
Big, juicy booty.
Big ass, look at that big, juicy booty.
Okay, Wolf, I'm going to full screen it. There you go.
Oh, no, we have passed the bar. You cannot hurt me anymore. The window of opportunity is closed.
Like, and don't get me wrong, I'm looking at it on the screen right now, and the proportion isn't nearly so whacked out as you're seeing there, because the camera's at, like, a down angle.
Yeah, yeah.
Like, it is wacky. Like, the arms are significantly bigger than they should be compared to the rest of the frame, but because of that down angle, it looks like he looks like a fucking little, yeah, like one of those
guys. Yeah, he's got He-Man
25 cent machine. Yeah,
Yeah, he made little tiny He-Man legs.
Like those old little dolls that were like the wrestlers with the
the muscle. Yeah, the muscle guys. Even the pose looks like a muscle guy, doesn't it?
It's got a lot of muscles too.
Yeah.
I didn't even vein him up.
So what is the fix about? I see blood all the time, but never.
What is the book about? No fucking idea, and Edwin wouldn't tell us because he's like.
Well, Edwin left like a long time ago, so who gives a shit what it's about?
No, what's the fix? Is that like a?
A grifter from Wildcats, something like that.
Oh yeah, it's a face cape. Yeah. Which again, I'll continue to defend. Like those existed.
What is this? What is this music? The AOC dancing on the roof. What is this from?
From when she was in college.
It was a video for promotion for something for her college.
Yeah.
I was like, she looks young and attractive here. What happened?
Yeah, she was like 18, 19. She was actually pretty at the time.
Like, hey, come join the AV club. We're cool, I swear.
I put out. Yeah.
Well, I guess somewhere along the way, her eyes bugged out.
And she got a horse face, like, in the
Yeah.
Like, she started off just looking like kind of a broad-faced Latina, and then she turned into Mr. Ed.
Yeah. Like there, like she's got like crazy fucking eyes and kind of a horse mouth, and one I could possibly overlook. Both at the same time, it is impossible.
That is rough.
I got a lot to lose, you know. I got married, I got kids. if you're gonna turn my head, you better be up there. Mm.
You better be a young Jessica Alba.
Yeah, mm-hmm. I mean, calling for no like you know late 20s. Mid-30s, mom. Just because you gave me a wink in the gun, you know?
That's okay. She wouldn't be interested in you. You're not white.
That's true.
Ouch.
Damn. Did she get... Are those fake teeth, too? That's... I thought it would go well.
I don't know who would actually get fake teeth and choose those.
But they're massive.
They are large.
No, you're not adopted. You think I'd pick you?
Like, I'm just saying, bitch can eat the fuck out of a carrot.
Hey, what up, Skip?
Skip Edwards.
What did Skip get here?
He was on the panel for a while.
From the beginning.
And muted himself to oblivion.
Yeah, yeah.
He says, Dillard... Is it white?
Oh shit, we doxed him.
I don't know.
Like he's less.
What do you think? What do you think?
He's less white than me.
Although you look like you've been picking blueberries all day.
Oh yeah, that's page stuff.
That's called poor circulation.
He still has another few days before they drop off. Draw, Michael, draw.
Dude, you got the beaties for sure.
No bullshit, motherfucker. No, check this out. I bleed.
Might be a leprosy. I don't know.
What?
Might be leprosy.
I look so heavy.
What, this one? Yeah, not bad.
Nah, I don't believe you.
Well, Michael, since you teased it, actually, I just had to Google the damn video.
Which one? The college one?
AOC dancing on a roof.
Yeah.
Send it to X in private, Dillard. I know you still got it open in the tab.
Oh, no, I already watched it.
Oh, okay. If he finished, it's gone.
Yeah. Hold on a second. Let's see.
Yeah, she could dance.
She could dance if she wants to.
Yeah, literally go into YouTube, search bar AOC dancing, and it's the first fucking video.
For real.
I'm not one to critique anybody's stance, but
yeah, I'm so confused. The big booty one is not on Fanatra's thing. It's just the Jewish space lasers.
I wasn't that Alex Stein who did that one?
Exactly. Yeah, I caught that.
Because he was in it, so I don't think Sinatra had any part of that one.
Be right back DMing Ethan.
Big booty Latina.
Now, there's a lot wrong with that Blade Silver. Number one, the steel's not awesome. But number two, the guard on it is already...
Oh, shit.
And I've never even, like, officially used it. Like, the company that makes it makes other stuff that's, like, better quality than this knife. This knife just looks cool, but it's straight up a wall hanger. Mm. Huh. The company's called Honshu. Yeah.
Which one's a wall hanger?
The knife. Like, it'll stab a motherfucker. Don't get me wrong, but it's not built to go into combat for any extended period of time. You hear that? Hold on.
The hell?
That's the guard.
That's the guard.
Oh my god.
Yeah.
It's like, I really want to take off the fucking scales and guard and like re-fucking tighten everything up on this.
Hello again, Courtney.
Wait, Courtney, you left?
What the fuck? If you're going to go through all that, you might as well just make your own damn knife.
You're right.
No, there's this movie that came out a while ago called Stardust.
Highlander. What?
Stardust.
Yeah.
Stardust, the guy that plays Daredevil in the Netflix series.
Charlie Cox, yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, it does. He plays Tristan, yeah, the main character. The dude has a sword in that movie that looks straight up like a 2.5-3 foot long butcher knife.
It was, yeah.
It's I always wanted. It looks like the biggest, heaviest machete cleaver you've seen in your life. Dope, dude. Yeah.
Claire Danes.
Yeah. Great. I own the Blu-ray. Love it.
Really? Like, I was going to say, like, it was an okay movie. I wouldn't have gone that far, but it was okay. I enjoyed watching it enough.
No, great movie. Best movie I've seen ever.
Sure.
Sir, I think you're confusing that with Starman.
And I've seen Terminator 2.
Now, for scale, there.
Apparently, Courtney went to camp with Claire Danes.
Do it, Mike.
Or she just said Claire. She could just mean any fucking Claire. I don't know.
Remember, kids, it's down the road, not across the street.
Depends on what your goal is.
You know. What? What? What's wrong with my hair? What?
Yeah, it's different.
You look like Steven Spielberg.
Well, the power of myth. I know that was George. Hmm. What's wrong with my hair, Courtney? What's going on? What about it?
What?
He's always combing his hair.
He's always conditioning his hair.
Where is it? It's on my fucking head.
Mostly on his back.
Yeah, the power of math. Yeah.
There we go.
Don't underestimate the power of meth. Oh, shit. The one person I was trying to impress doesn't like it. Damn it.
What happened?
Yeah.
Jason Black's icon looks like a buff-ass Keanu.
That would be the image generated, yes.
I'm almost done with my suit.
I didn't cut my hair. My head grew.
You cut your hair?
No. That's what I keep telling people. I did it 2 weeks ago, Courtney.
Man looks like a young Richard Dreyfuss.
I am trying to think of lines from Jaws and can right now. That belong to Richard Dreyfuss. I can think of lines from Jaws, but no, I am wiped. So, Skip, tell everybody where you can be found.
It's only 4 a.m.
It's late.
Skip isn't here, Michael.
No, sir. Skip. No, where'd you go?
I mean, like, what? This is a new show, right? You've only just started doing this, where you take CG icons and you draw them.
The draw stream idea that takes place after Red Valkyrie's regen cycle was started by McMahon, Mike McMahon, U.S. Assassin, and all that. But he had life shit happen, and I took over for a while, and then I wasn't able to do it on Friday nights, and then so there was nothing. I can start doing Friday nights again, so I'm bringing it back until he can come back.
All right. I understand all that, but from the time that you stopped doing it to the time that you restarted doing it now on Fridays,
oh, it's been like Fridays.
How many Fridays has it been that you're doing these CGI?
This concerts? Is the first. You were on the re-debut stream.
I don't know why you had to give me such a roundabout answer when you said yeah.
It's all part of the nationality questionnaire. I'm not going to waste my time arguing with.
I don't understand anything anybody's talking in the chat.
Richard Dreyfuss line, yeah.
Ah.
From Shaw's?
You were on the Indianapolis. What? Oh, she's throwing more. You didn't give me a yes-no question. Duh, exactly. Dillard, you didn't understand the assignment.
This is an evasive individual. Mission to treat the witness as hostile.
Want better answers? Ask better questions.
Your Honor, my client clearly declares whoopsie-daisy. Mm. Keep you in the loop, Skip? Betty White died.
There you go. Abe Vigoda, dead now.
What? Bullshit.
Wait, Betty White died, what, today?
No, not today. It's like a year
I'm
or two
keeping
ago.
Skip in the loop. I'm keeping Skip in the loop of things since last I hung out with him at all.
Reagan is no longer president.
Aerosmith had to cancel their finale tour,
but they did do a mean team up with Run DMC.
Run DMC is still out there.
I'm the only person that hates that stupid.
Most of them are dead.
Are you, the only you guys with me? You guys which like one? Walk This Way?
Yeah,
the original is better than the Run DMC version.
Yes, yeah, but right. I can only sing the Run DMC version.
As far as Aerosmith songs go, yeah, it's way down on the list for me.
But it was a cool move for crossover.
It was revolutionary and all that shit. But seeing where rap turned out, mistake.
Yeah. I saw.
Seeing where rock turned out as well.
I saw Reverend Run with Kid Rock. But, in the last 10 years. It was a fucking good show. Wasn't expecting it.
We only kicked you, Skip, because of your views towards the Jews and the blacks.
I thought it was because of his rampant love for stepmother porn.
I mean,
we need to take it up. The Jew stuff isn't funny enough because we can't assign them we need to assign them a color.
So you got the browns, the blacks, the reds, the yellows, the whites. So, yeah, I get it. Mm-hmm. Kid Rock sucks good too. What?
He might do, but I'm not going to take him up on it.
$50 is $50, I guess.
You're gross. Yeah, oh, you're pink.
At least part of you is pink. I can pretty much guarantee that.
I'm no gynecologist, but I'll take a look.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yeah, John, I like the... I just got a good look at the character. This Sebastian.
Yeah, the eye's freaking baller.
Yeah,
it's good. Yeah, it's Sebastian.
Yeah. Actually, the knife is really good. The knife is kind of the shining point of that piece at the moment.
Good was
he ain't got no hand. He got broken up.
Our sentences. I won't apologize. I love Sammy Davis Jr.
Who doesn't?
Everyone's pink on the inside. Well, you got to cook them proper, Silvar.
They're usually red. Really? A little blue and purple in some places. Oddly green.
I just assumed that crabs, all crabs, grow back their claws. So if this guy had an unfortunate accident, because I believe he lost his closing pincer on top, because these particular crabs, Jamaican tropical crabs, whatever, their pincers are on top instead of on the bottom. Like the top is the movable part. So I don't know. Wouldn't he just, if he was a G, right, and it broke off, wouldn't he just be like, just take it at the elbow. I'll get another one soon, you know? Rip the rest off.
Oh, Dillard is now the expert on all crabs.
Yes, yes.
I used to have crabs for years.
Phrasing.
I had a 230-gallon saltwater fish tank for a long time. Lots of crabs. Mm-hmm. Big. Never saw them grow anything back, though.
Yeah, don't they rip the claws off of the crabs and then chuck them back in the water so they can grow new ones and they take those too?
Maybe. Sounds good.
I don't know. Christy? She was the one studying to be a marine biologist, so. She likes the ocean. I find it terrifying. But I like space. I don't get it.
Yeah, I'd rather be in space than, well, fuck. I'm in the ocean often enough. So.
Fuck it. You, sir, are in the Canadian Rockies. You're not in the ocean often enough.
Well, I travel enough. And like, I still have the house with my wife in San Diego. So I swim there all the time. Or did at the time. Before she switched the keys and whatnot. You know how it is.
Like they do, yeah.
Yeah, women.
Well, hey, it's one thing to pop by your own lady's house.
That's the most depressing thing. Talk about the ex-wife, then you hear the microwave going on.
Oh, a man, a can, and a plan.
Goddamn right.
Yeah. I'll just heat up some yesterday's dinner here.
Damn, it's not even today's microwave dinner? Shit.
No, it's a coffee. So, yeah. It's fine.
Microwave leftovers.
It's a cup of joe.
I simply cannot finish this humongous Hungry Man Salisbury steak.
Oh,
save it for tomorrow.
Yeah. Saving the mashed potatoes for breakfast.
Honey, we need to get some Salisbury steak.
Shit ain't bad.
No, she actually has a homemade recipe for it, so it's fucking awesome. It's not the microwave.
Mm. Nice.
Bet you think you're better than me now.
I mean, a little bit.
No, I'm just, I don't know why I'm acting. This is going to be an outline because I'm painting it.
It's habit. Sometimes
it's hard to stop drawing how you draw.
Yeah. Yeah, like you have a tactic and you just kind of fall right into it, you know?
Mm-hmm.
Watched a vid about a half male, half female lobster, literally half blue, half red.
That's bizarre.
Yeah.
Is that how lobsters divide themselves up?
Yes, yes.
Yeah, the boys wear blue and the girls wear red.
Yeah. Some of them have one star and some of them have two.
Dude, if you guys, you know, they have blue lobsters, like, naturally, right?
Yep.
They're gorgeous. Like,
crazy. I don't know. I ain't never been to a blue lobster.
I've been to a red lobster.
I've been to a red lobster.
Yeah, no, we Angela, already did, Angela. Basically, what happened was Michael's work told him to clean up his appearance because he's a slovenly mess, or he's going to get his ass shit canned.
Actually, my work doesn't give a shit, and I'm okay. You know, it's like... And then the guy with the star removing truck arrives.
No, the real story is he has no idea how it happened. He woke up like this.
Yep. I'm pretty sure I'm in another reality. Mm. One of those mandala things. Mm-hmm. Oh my God, I'm tired. Okay, I'm calling. This is my stream. I'm going to call it. Holy shit. Xevious, where can people find you, brother?
You can find me over here on YouTube, here and there. You can find me on Michael's channel right here, perhaps on Fridays, Sundays as often as I can. And you can find me daily on Twitter and Instagram doing art and talking politics and whatever. Keep me up to date on Canada.
Limiting his use of electricity.
Yeah. I currently have a live picture of Canada as my background. Dillard.
That's not Canada at all.
You
can find me on Twitter and YouTube under Dillard Draws.
Right there in the corner.
Expert extraordinaire. Dillard Draws, Chrome Dog Expert, and CG Darling.
Absolutely.
But first and foremost, Chrome Dog Expert. Points there to Courtney go. For the best joke of the night.
Looks like Manitoba.
That isn't Michael. It's Frog G.
This is Manitoba.
Salud.
Hi there. You can find me on Twitch on Sundays, but you won't. You can find me on the MMM on Sunday nights. You probably will, if you know what's good for you.
You know where most of you live. I have the mailing lists.
We're on Ellie's on Thursday, where at least we have Mo. You can find me on Twitter, and if you want to, you will.
You're on two little shitty islands.
CG it's plays with desert! Them. Nothing grows here! Nothing's gonna grow here!
Move where the food is!
We have deserts in America, too! We just don't live in them!
Hmm. Hi, I'm Michael T. from High Desert Comics. Yes, we do live in them. It's a shit idea, but we do.
It's true.
Yeah, you can find me.
But we ship food in from close.
Via catapult. You can find me and Wolvo here on Sunday afternoons, America time, doing CG Plays With Itself. We're idiot gamers who do idiot game things and talk about comics while we do it. Mm-hmm. MMM, Monday Morning Marathon, Sunday nights to Monday mornings. And yeah, Wolvo will be there too. Shipbird Militia, hail from the Netherworld.
Hey, how you go?
You're just in time for the sign off. Sup.
Yeah.
And Friday nights, as often as possible, I will be doing CG icons and artists that are out there doing projects and drawing stuff up. More than welcome to come in. The format is bullpen, and Wolvo will judge from on high.
Yeah.
That being said,
why the fuck is Xevious here? He's not showing nothing.
Yeah, it's a little fancy for me.
This is his vocal rehab. We have to let him in here.
Yeah, it's true. It's the best I got.
Yeah.
Find me in Comics Mate's comic section. Yes, go sub to Comics Mate. Everybody here already has.
Get him in the comments. How about that?
I should pull the trigger on subbing to Dean.
Call him Dean's, a Nazi in the comments.
Dean's been doing some good little short videos lately.
Will he give me a wrench?
In the comments, maybe. About that.
He will definitely send a heart your way. How's that?
Nice.
Right. Jason, put the bug in his ear. He's got a wrench, Dillard. A yahtzee? What the?
I think Yappy has is some inside thing from the comments.
Okay.
Dean all referenced right. Yappy a few times.
Thank you, everybody. You all have a good night, and we is the fucks out of here. Peace.
Later.
Peace.